right, gentlemen, let's play.
We can feel the excitement up in the comm box. First ball.
Oh, yeah, one, easy one.
Off the mark straight away. Andrew Fletcher.
And some early pressure being exerted by Karen Pollard, certainly for Andrew Fletcher. He will come out of that bad part position for Rakim Cornwall. Rakim Cornwall has an exceptional strike rate in the Hero CPL. Fielders out, deep mid wicket, long off. Karen Pollard going straight behind the bowler. Very unusual field placement, but because he likes to go straight down, a good option.
Just nearly sneaked through with the angle of the arm from round the wicket. Uses the new ball to get that angle into right-handers. That's one of the ways that he's been so effective with the ball. As you saw there, not trying to spin the ball very early. Now Rakim Cornwall will have a very important role in this Kings team. And that will be for them to continue being the best in terms of run per over in the power play, 8.7. That's what the Kings have achieved.
Catch it, Pollard!
Pollard settles and takes the catch. Plan coming to fruition. And an El Dorado celebration.
Akil Hussein once again gets the Trinbago Knight Riders off to a good start. Not a good start for the St. Lucia Kings. Karen Pollard positioning himself just behind the bowler. Ali Khan might have taken this catch as well. Not too sure, but very certain from Pollard. And look at that celebration. Early blow, early wicket. Not much of an impact today for Cornwall. Goes without scoring one for one.
Coming to the crease now, number 27, Mark Dial. The score 1-1.
Yeah. Son, do this one. I'll let Hockey do that one. All right, Baba. Oh, who this? Mark! In here very early, boy.
Mark Dial, the left-hander, batting at number 3. Not only is he important for run scoring, but because he's a left-hander, he will prove crucial against the two left-arm orthodox spinners in this TKR team.
Wasn't expecting to be out there in the first over here. Okay, come on, boy.
And Aki Lucien is such a skillful bowler into the pitch. It's the fifth wicket Aki Lucien has taken in the first over that he's bowled. Really exceptional stuff.
Goes downtown. Confident looking shot, a live boy, clean strike from Dial. End of the over, 5-1. Already for the Knight Riders, Aaron Pollard leading his troops. Strategy immediately shown by the Knight Riders and the captain himself doing the business with the catch. He's the patriarch of this TKR family, not only for his batting but his cricketing acumen as well. Those things have proven to be crucial for TKR's success.
Ravi Rampol, joint lead and wicket taker in this edition of the Hero CPL, missed a couple seasons in the Hero CPL, but boy, hasn't he returned with a bang. His sons, both his sons, cheering him on. Riley and Raul and TKR family in the house. TKR family there as well. Colin, our songman, what's he doing? Who's he supporting?
Two fielders, leg side. Boundary riders, as if to indicate Rampol will test Dale with a short delivery. Still a slip in play as well. Still goes for it. Does he get enough? Yes. Goes all the way for a Hero Maximum. That's courageous from Dial.
Fortune favors the brave. As you mentioned, very courageous. Taking on the fielder. Gets enough off it. From Rampol. Rampol has already dismissed him twice this season. Once first ball. Today, it's Dale who gets Rampol first ball for a Hero Maximum. Wonderful intent being shown by Mark Dale.
How does Rampol respond? Goes full. Gets an unusual boundary. He'll take it. So to the Kings.
Yeah, inadvertent from Dial. Could have so easily ricocheted onto the stumps. But again, fortune favoring the Brave. Gets the boundary. 10 runs from two balls. Mark Dial against Ravi Rampol, who's had the better of him previously. One day for you, one day for me.
Andy Flaw, Darren Sammy, Faf du Plessis will hope that Mark Dale could bat deep into this innings. Not many left-handers in this Kings batting lineup. So that left-hand, right-hand combination will add a little more pressure on the TKR bowlers. Beautiful, terrific shot by DL. He's looking on sound.
He finds the middle of the bat through the offside. Tried a similar shot previously, got an inside edge. This time, it's a really commanding shot. Slower ball, maybe a little bit too full, and a good shot once again from Mark DL. Turning the heat on, semi-final, big game. Really an opportunity for this St. Lucia Kings team, for Mark Dale and all of the others, to make a profound statement.
Brilliant. After a boundary, an easy single to end the over. 21 for one.
Cruise ship just touching down here in Bastia, St. Kitts and Nevis. So some economic activity much needed in these times.
We will sail away into the final at the end of this first semi-final in Hero CPL 2021. Akhil Hussain will continue his bowling from the commentary box end.
Akhil,
Straight to the fielder. Samuel Badria did mention that the TKRs are four-time champions. They'll be well aware of playing under the pressure of a knockout match. St. Lucia Kings not yet with a title. Playing a miss. But you also must take into account the fact that this St. Lucia Kings team, they've beaten all the teams in the semi-finals.
You don't mind that. You forget this angle.
Dream 11, Fantasy League. Make sure you pick your team, win prizes. Get the best players. You pick the captain that performs well, you double your points.
Well bowled.
So you can't really underestimate St. Lucia Kings. They played well in the group stage, so they can be real competitive unit on any given day.
Something's gonna happen again. Keep going, Akil.
Five wides, two straight from Akil Hussein, and a little bit untidy from Dennis Ramden. Usually he will clean this up, not today. So useful runs for the St. Lucia Kings, and I quite agree with you. A very good team, and I like their depth. I quite like the depth that they have to offer.
It's all about the vibes. It's win or go home. You don't know.
That he plays as well throughout this.
It's going to be
CPL,
watch and
DJ
see.
Flames.
DJ Flame representing. Rob, big up yourself.
Gets it right this time. An Omega XL hit. He flattered to deceive a couple of deliveries before. Nails it.
Yeah, Akil Hussein bowling over the wicket. Just a little bit concerned about that angle. I much prefer to see him bowling round the wicket and trying to go across the left-hander, especially in the power play. Maybe bowl some more arm balls. Over the wicket, the angle really assists the batsman, especially if you're trying to turn it. So we'll see if he makes that accommodation. The St. Lucia Kings have scored significantly more runs off boundaries than the Knight Riders in this edition. Kings have 123 fours and 72 sixes before the start of this game, as compared to 102 fours and 68 sixes for the Knight Riders. So they've scored more in terms of both fours and sixes.
Yeah, a lot of goals coming from their leading run scorers, Faf du Plessis. Force change, not playing today. You can also download the CPL chat app. Get on it, chat with the commentators, chat amongst yourselves as spectators and supporters of the respective teams. Wonderful conduit to interact and enjoy the Hero CPL 2021 even a bit more.
And I'm just looking at the ticker on the bottom there. Andre Fletcher, I didn't even realize he was out there. Mark DL has been doing the bulk of the scoring. Just the two deliveries faced from Andre Fletcher. Andre Fletcher has played 88 CPL games before this, the most for any player on the St. Lucia Kings team. So vastly experienced. And with that added responsibility of captaincy today, he would want to fire. Mark Dale, of course, familiar with a lot of these players because he is from Trinidad and Tobago as well.
Brilliant. With the change in feel, works the ball through the onside, picks up two. Now what he's also doing well, he's taking over the role that usually Rakeem Cornwall plays in this side. It's the first time Cornwall was dismissed by a spinner in this edition of Hero CPL. And Mark DL has come and played and filled that role perfectly so far for the Kings. Goes again. There is protection. Just a single, but it's another expensive over. 14 runs coming from it. 35 for one.
Yeah, really good start for the St. Lucia Kings. They've lost an early wicket in Rakeem Cornwall, but the batsmen haven't let that deter them in terms of their intent. Well, certainly Mark Dial, given that clear responsibility to go after the bowling. So far, so good.
Significantly, Faf du Plessis out of the St. Lucia Kings team today with a groin injury. Beam Aline gets another opportunity on debut. He picked up 3 wickets. Really troubled the scorers. And thus far, it's been the Dial show. 28 from 13.
We oftentimes talk about strategy and tactics, but the decision to send Mark Dial at 3, the left-handedness, has proven successful so far. It has forced Sunil Narine to be introduced into the attack, and it changes nothing for Mark Dial. Dispatches him for a 4 off the first ball, continues to get boundaries.
I just like the clarity in thought from Mark Dial. Doesn't look like he's premeditating. Usually as a T20 batsman, it's so important for you to keep in that zone where you're not overthinking about a possible gap or an area of strength that you have as a batsman.
One-way traffic here, one-way. Come on.
Keep going. One way. Can you see greater challenge here? Now for Sunil Narine. He's a wily fox with that white ball. Can he be smarter than the ball itself?
Yeah. Easy to.
Sensible, really intelligent from Mark Dial. He's getting the boundaries, but he's also looking to get the ones and twos when they're available. And oftentimes throughout this tournament, I've mentioned the additional motivation of playing against your home territory. Mark Dial playing against Trinbago Knight Riders, so he has an additional point to prove. 33 of 15, I just want to see him push on. He's gotten these sort of starts before. What a day for him to really carry on and get a big half century, at least.
Just pulled out at the last minute, so.
Dot him up here, boys.
Sunil Narine, 11 wickets so far in the tournament. Also very good economy. An appeal for the stumping, and Dayton Butler goes upstairs.
It'll be interesting to see how this one goes. Not too confident, but there's always that chance of that back foot being raised. Good, legitimate delivery from Sunil Narine. Foot well behind the crease, while cutting the crease, but just this back foot here, it always goes out. Does it come back in time? Yes, it does. So he is safe. Andre Fletcher, and is this the right approach from him, given the fact that Mark Dial is going quite well?
You should see not out. Yep, confirmation there. Andre Fletcher, just get a single. That should be his plan. No need to match Mark Dial. Narine twice taken Fletcher's wicket.
And you're just hearing Dennis Ramden saying to dot him up. Karen Pollard quite close in that mid-wicket region. Fielders on the offside will be trying to cut the single just to get some dot deliveries in.
Oh yes. Blocking them up all these here, boy.
Surprise, he's not looking to use his sweep shot in the circumstances. Narine from round the wicket. Very difficult for an umpire to judge LBW from that angle.
They have a good start. 41 in the fourth over. You can afford to soak up a few dot deliveries. Just don't get out. It's a good foundation that's being laid. And you're up against the premier spinner in the Trinbago Knight Riders team. Just ride this tough period out.
Volley hustle. Locking up volley here. That's a
Six from the over, 41 for one.
St. Lucia Kings winning the toss and opting to bat first. Andrew Fletcher indicated that that's their strength and they want to continue with that trend.
Ali Chan is the new bowler. Number 23 of this Paul South will be the center end.
Intense contests at the moment, as mentioned during the group stage, match number 7, St. Lucia Kings got the better of the Knight Riders, winning by 5 runs, and then the Knight Riders responded in match number 9, and they went on to win by 27 runs. Time for a change in bowling, Ali Khan. Crispy struck, another hero maximum. Wow.
Mark Dial is in sublime form. 39 from 16 deliveries. 3 sixes and 4 fours so far. Magnificent strike off the bowling of Ali Khan, the first delivery. As you mentioned, Darren, very uncomplicated approach. Sea ball, hit ball.
Well, hello and goodbye, Ali Khan. And again, take 4, Dial. Races now past his highest score against the Knight Riders, which was scored last year. This is a really good effort so far.
And brings up the 50 for the St. Lucia Kings in only the 5th over. A blistering start. And exactly what they were looking for, if not from Dial, from Cornwall, but it's Dial. Brilliant stuff. 1 for 1 when he walked in to bat. It's 51 for 1 now.
Well played, Andrew Fletcher. Solid contribution there in that partnership. Yeah, I did mention 40 runs that Mark Dial scored in Hero CPL 2020. It was in the group stage when the Kings took on the Knight Riders. We got to 40. You won't beat Andre Russell, but this is a really special innings from the young man. 43 already from 18 deliveries. 3 hero maximums, 5 fours.
And immediately the Trinbago Knight Riders bowlers under some pressure. They've been quite good throughout the season with the ball. Haven't been faced with this sort of proposition before. Real intent.
And Samuel Badri, Karen Pollard will know that this St. Lucia Kings team, they've lost the least amount of wickets across all teams in the middle overs, just 23 wickets. So that's another good phase for the Kings with the bat, and that's yet to come. A lot of that batting in the middle has been because of Faf du Plessis and how he's gone about scoring runs at times. Andre Fletcher with his solitary half century, but Roston Chase as well, the leading run scorer. He's been instrumental in that start, that positive start for the Kings. Yeah, there he is, all smiles, and why not?
Yeah, his consistency throughout this tournament, very commendable and laudable. The way he's accumulated his runs, his strike rate, not something that you would really look for from Roston Chase, but he's proven all of his critics wrong that he is, in fact, an all-format player.
Off target, Ali Khan. Not a good sign if you're a TKR fan. Let's appreciate what Mark Dial has done in this innings. Only 5 runs through the offside. Whether that's an area of strength, but surely they've been bowling too close lines. Maybe too short as well. Strike rate of 226.
I think it's the first over I can remember Ali Khan bowling from this, the pavilion end. He's done most of his bowling from the Lozak Road end.
Quick single. Turns the strike over. Still, 2 legal deliveries remaining. They've gone upstairs to just check and ensure that he was home safely.
Just having a look maybe at the height of that delivery. And then possibly the direct hit run out. Let's have a look first of all for the height. It seems to be okay. Fair delivery confirmed, so that's okay. Let's look at the direct hit now. Does he ground? Yes, he does. So all good for the St. Lucia Kings. Not the best technique, boys and girls, young cricketers.
It was a plunker.
But all is well, that ends well for the Kings. Final delivery from Ali Khan. Expensive start for him. 8 wickets so far in the tournament in only the 3 games, Ali Khan.
So legal delivery of the last one, 1 delivery remaining. Make that 1 more again.
Yeah, they seem to be a little bit off this morning. The Trinbago Knight Riders haven't seen them often in this sort of situation. How can they respond? Red, white and black supporters for the Knight Riders, of course supporters for the St. Lucia Kings, wherever you guys may be in St. Lucia, around the Caribbean and around the globe, willing your team on. Can this be the year of the Kings?
Good bounce and pace. Dot delivery to end the over.
So power play's got 1 to go in it. Mark Dial, this is great stuff. He's in fairly quiet. He's shown glimpses with the bat, but he's by and large had a pretty quiet time of it in season 9 here.
Oh yes, one's the easy one, Polly. Easy.
And we've been saying at length here, left and right hand combinations so key for openers. Yeah, 100 millionth bike. Produced recently since 1984. Hero Honda, you little beauty. The Hero Motor Corp, as they say, they've surpassed 1 million motorcycles, let alone the tires that go with it. And number one cycle and scooter company in the last 20 years. cat and mouse stuff here. Ian Bishop alongside to win the toss. I think runs on the board. Key mentioned that was Simon Dool pre-show. I think this is bodes well for those in blue. The repeat of last year's final two, Bish.
Catch him, Gary. Good work. Come on.
And you're so unbiased, being the consummate pro you are. Who would you like to win, just as an emotional side, not a statistical mind, or go with your heart? Because I know you're from Port of Spain. But what do you reckon? Who would you like to win? The whole thing.
Not getting involved in that at all. Whoever wins, wins. We are here to be objective, Danny Morrison, as best as we can.
Well, of course, you have to be. It's not bad. It's interesting, isn't it, where someone takes the bulk of the strike, and Mark Dale clearly has had that. And Fletcher, who obviously can go some as well, having to weigh anchor, and he's seen his mate disappear, Cornwall for a duck. Yeah, just think in mind, strategy, give the strike back as much to MD. The order of the morning. Oh, the old French one. You're going to take one and be happy. Pitch looks a lot better, though, Bish.
This pitch has consistently perhaps been the best of the tournament, and even for this semi-final, given the number of games played on it in the last few days, it looks as good as I've seen it.
Yeah, spot on. The ground staff were saying, yeah, they'd love to be in the middle, but this has been the best of the three, without a doubt. No, Fletch, just calm down. So there's the power play done. 58 for one, the Kings.
Number 18, Kyrie Pierre of the Paul Soper Media End.
So the Guardian Life power play is all done. Almost bang on tens. St. Lucia Kings having won the toss, if you've just tuned in. And no hesitations from Andre Fletcher, of course, being in for the injured Faf du Plessis, who can't take the field with the groin injury he sustained a couple of days ago. So part of the left-arm spin twins. Got Carrie Pierre back in the side. And you think Akil Hussain. So the two lefties. And then you throw in that with Sunil Narayan. So they really have gone for spin, and more of it in the day games. Clean and straight. Beautiful Mark Dayal. And what a way to bring up 50. For this very talented left-hander in a semi-final.
He's played with freedom, and that must be commendable to him given his lack of runs this season previously. His job would be to come in, capitalize on the power play, but now it's about kicking on, and he has a free spirit about him, a rarer moment if ever there was one.
And boom! Here's another one. Oh, I'm loving this. What a great way to start up against a bowler who's been in superb form. Just to say, hey, I'm here too, Carrie Pierre. Yeah, great striking. Talk about locking this one away. He's on the charge. Is Mark Dale, and certainly with a Rario moment, because you can now own your favourite cricket moments on Rario.com. It's part of the CPL's official NFT partner in this digital world. Yeah, some for the Rario vault locker there. Already from Mark Dale, 59 from 25, and there's a salute to bring up the half ton.
One run out.
Of course, Fletcher doesn't have to do anything outrageous.
Okay, use them areas. Use them areas,
Dre Russ, who'll forget? Against the Kings, wasn't it? Put them to the sword and carved it up. And 14 ball half century at the start of this tournament.
Hurry.
Last one.
Yes, yes, you got it.
It's ideal for the Kings because Mark Dale's going to keep the strike. 15 off the seventh, and the Kings are 73 for one. Splendid conditions here. In fact, the breeze isn't too strong, quite warm indeed. Here just after 10:35 local Eastern Caribbean time. Just the big fella out, Rakeem Cornwall. Didn't trouble the scorers. Fell on that first over. So no surprises with the strategy with his spin up front against Cornwall and Co. So just a change of gloves here for Mark Dale with a bit of time. Yeah, a bit to think about, a bit to contemplate here for TKR.
Yeah, what Mark Dale has done is shown us once again, or reminded us, how matchups work in this form of the game. The left-arm spinners of TKR are an incredible asset for them all season, over the years as well. And he's managed to face a lot of their bowling in this game, take them on, put pressure on them. And so how long can they be kept out of the attack while he is there? Strike rate of 171 against them in his career.
Time for Ravi from his preferred end, Rumpole. Maybe one there. Yeah, but it's been a splendid innings, Bish. Good to watch.
Yeah, he's played his role to perfection. And he's talked openly about wanting to get out of the power play and kick on deep into the overs batting. He doesn't just want to use the power play to do it as well as he's done. I have a different view about how Fletcher should play. And I'm not saying I'm right and anyone else is wrong. It's just a different view. I don't believe that on such a good pitch, your strike rate should be 30 when another guy is going at 225. That's not good cricket. I'm not saying throw your hand away. That's not what I'm saying.
Well, he has Ian Bishop. Republic Bank Classic from Munro with a good technique sliding and making sure he holds on.
And maybe he needed to go because he's striking at 28.57. But that's a breakthrough TKR would welcome. And they've got the captain of the Kings. Rampal goes to 19 wickets, leading the tournament. Fletcher goes for 474 for two.
And then Fletcher is winning number two for the Sandwich Kings. The score now 74 for two. He was out caught by Monroe, bowled by Ravi Rampal. New man of the trees, number 22, Weston Chase. 7.2 overs bowled, score once again 74 for two.
Man of the tournament in a way, in terms of consistency, Roston Chase. Tremendous time here in season 9, Hero CPL. And these conditions will suit his type of play. But, now you look at this tournament, look at those great numbers that he's produced. Well, as Ian Bishop said, he wants to go deep, Mark Dale, post the power play. It's a great opportunity for Mark Dale. Given he is from Trinidad and Tobago. So it just adds a bit to it. He really wants to do well. But Bish, well, you almost got on cue.
Yeah, my philosophy on partnerships is this. If the wicket and the conditions are offering you X number of runs, Mark Dale has gone very good strike rate of 221. There's no need if the other batsman gets a boundary ball to just tuck it away for one. That doesn't come back to you. If you get a boundary ball, put it away. There's no reason if conditions are good and you've got the depth of batting that the Kings have, there's no reason why the other guy can't go at a strike rate of 130, 140. No reason whatsoever. Maximize the conditions on which you're batting.
100%. It has got so much better this this strip. Just a nice little clip here. You're going about partnerships, and of course, stating the obvious here, these two for me in a sudden death semi-final, huge.
Look at the all-round purpose as well. You don't know what a good total is. It's a good surface. So again, hear what I'm saying. I'm not saying take risks and be stupid at the other end. But play the conditions as it is presented to you.
And again, Mickey Skerritt on the right, the president of Cricket West Indies. Dear fellow. He used to be the tourism minister here too. St. Kitts and Nevis. Yeah, well, as we said so often as well, whatever you do first, do it well. Might be a wide. I think you'll have to reload that one. Yeah, given the challenging nature of the surfaces, Bish, we've moved across the whole of the square, and there's only three pitches after all. And a lot of grass at the start of the tournament, and a bit shaved off, and still it was turning and a little uneven. Ball sitting in the pitch a bit. I think maybe some of the teams got a little greedy early on what they wanted to try and post, as opposed to what you're saying is, now let's just assess what's going on in front of us today, this morning, rather than at night as well. So Chase is going to hold on to the strike. Six off the eighth, 79 for two. Celebrity Equinox is the name of this wonderful holiday ocean line. Look at that. Look at that. In terms of shots here, it just shows you how close it is. Oh, quite a little Angostura chill refreshing moment sitting back on the luxury liner. We'll send Alex.
Chance for TKR, on the other hand, while a lot of the discussion, 98% of it, has been about the excellence of the Kings, can TKR now pull things back? Chase, usually a good play of spin, fallen to Hussein already this season. Who can they use now in these middle overs? Can you hide? That's one of the questions I had. As you saw Dial going in the power play, where could you hide one ball to get him off strike to get back to Fletcher? I didn't think that was done as effectively by some of the bowling. Narine was good of TKR. They could have maybe got him to hit one to deep square leg, get him to hit one down to long on for a single, bowl at Fletcher, who was struggling.
Now, Sunil Narayan at the best of times against anyone. With the pressure of the power play and then the mindset of the batters thinking, got to score, have to score inside the six overs. Hence why Narayan is used so often by so many franchises in this format.
Oh,
a little bit of freedom here. Is that a little bit of extra flight, almost like a sucker ball, to say, come on, Marcus, you want to keep going, don't you? You're on a roll. Long off, of course. Deep backward point. Man at deep backward square and mid-wicket on the fence, and long on. So lots of protection now for Akhil Hussain. Thinking two in a gap. Not this time. So Timmy Seifert out there. A couple of Kiwis hunting up in the boundary on the onside.
Good work, yeah, man. Come on. Again and again. Come on.
Drone cam in these modern times, very spoilt. A wonderful vista of the ground and the surroundings. Pollard and then revving his side up post that wicket of Fletcher. Yeah, nice. The control of Roston Chase, because he's in such good touch. Nothing outrageous, just sensible. Let's give the strike back as much as I can to Mark Dale, who's striking at still 206. Five fours, five maximums. To the left-hander, Mark Dale. Yeah, it's been a good little over this. Only four singles. So what is Roston Chase thinking here? Knowing how well Hussain has gone in season nine. A little bit off the straight. Hard ball. It's still only nearly nine overs old. And going off the straight. He has... done that with great consistency, as Hussain. Well bowled. So just five off the ninth. And St. Lucia Kings are 84 for two. We're going to have Ali Khan from his preferred end as well, I have to say. Got pumped from this, the pavilion end. And this is the end, the city end of Warner, where he's actually got his wickets from. Either swinging it with the new ball or tailing with the old one. Let's see what he's going to go here with some pace. And he disappears straight away. It almost goes for six here. One bounce for four for the start of the 10th.
Shot of a man in form. Chase's run rate is now 150. So you see what I'm talking about. While they've come out of the power play, Dial has gone a little bit quiet. But now 376 runs. Candidate for hero of the CPL. Slight change in the field. Deep square, deep mid-wicket, long on.
Yeah, again, that homework on a particular batsman. Can't bowl here. Those are very friendly. Thank you very much. Through cover here. Roston Chase.
Simply about finding gaps, not overpowering the ball. Seven fours, five sixes. It's a high boundary count. You've got to find a way, I suppose, as a bowler to dry that up.
Yeah, a little out of sorts. Isn't it funny? He started late in the tournament. He got wickets and the dynamic spell, wasn't it? Four for six. And there's four overs. This fella, Ali Khan, and he's just giving himself a stretch here. The amount of groin injuries and niggly hammies we've had here in season nine, understandable with the condensed nature. Then he travelled a bit, and then he came back and got more wickets. So he's just blown a bit of hot and cold here, Ali Khan. Just having a discussion here with his skipper, just seeing how he is, because he's still only into his second over. So they expect four overs out of Ali Khan, a specialist, either with a new ball or at the death. It's such a key component for TKR.
Well, I think it's a situation like this today from Pollard's point of view. He could bowl an over or two on the surface with his little cutters if the ball is coming on as beautifully as it is. And to be fair to Dale, he didn't only take on the spinners, he took on the seamers too.
Just noticed there's definitely a lack of follow through and energy with that last one, given that he's gone for two fours and a wide. So as a bowler, you want to come back, fight back and run in and bowl your best next delivery or two. I just think he's lumbering here. He's just not quite at 100%. Yeah, hardly a follow through. And normally he'd be a lot further down the pitch. Yeah, I think confirmation here. He's starting to struggle and possibly seize up a little. Pollard's having to have a chat. Can you finish the over, please? It would be ideal. He's got three to go. Does not want to bowl another wide or no ball at all.
It's a key point Danny Morrison just made, a key point. And it's a phrase of what is your best ball under pressure? Pollard has been having discussions with Ali Khan, for example, at the top of his mark. They've come up with what is the best delivery you can bowl in the situation. And you've got to, if he hits you for four, let's say it's a length ball, back of a length, top of off. Let him hit you from there. And if he hits you from there, DL or Chase, you accept that. Put up your hand and say, your day, your innings. But when you're bowling full tosses and ill-line deliveries, you're hard on yourself then as a bowler, because you're committing unforced errors.
Yeah, and then of course the stress level mentally, what am I going to come back with? If you are indeed, as it looks like with Ali Khan, struggling, really struggling. I think he's going to come off here. Still a delivery to go, I believe, yeah. So, maybe, no? Yeah, we're not far from the Angostura chill break, just the one delivery. Yeah, and one of his best balls, as we know, Bish, is a go-to Yorker, and he's tried that there. And you've set the field according long on, long off, and go full. So,
Well, they've gone for Dale lately, he's full and wide as well, forcing him because he scored so proficiently boundaries leg side, they've gone full and wide of late.
Spot on, Bish. He's got protection, let's see. Yep, he finished it well. So just the one. So 13 off the 10th.
He does a great job, as the whole crew have. Bring you these wonderful pitches and sounds throughout the last 3.5 weeks of Hero CPL action. Jason Holder. Just wait for our man. There he is. There he is. Charging out there, racing Jason Holder. Brilliant stuff. Where are we at? Morning to you, Darren.
Morning, Simon Dool. Hello, everyone.
Chance. Pollard can't get around, no.
Mark Dial has a chance to anoint himself as royalty in this St. Lucia kingdom. And has a chance to score a century, a T20 century. Come on, young man, move on from peasant status. So far, so good. 68 from 35.
Oh, straight and wonderfully hit again from Mark Dayal. Not sure that that has gone all the way, but placement, absolutely brilliant.
He can do no wrong, Mark Dayal. 5 euro maximums, 6 fours. Strike rate of exactly 200, and he's punished every bar delivery.
That's 4, isn't it? Just bounced short. Or is it hit on the full or not? Yeah. I'm going to roll back. Let's have a look at this coming down now. Does it? Oh, might have hit on the full, actually. That might be 6. Might be another hero maximum for Mark Dayal. It is. Confirmation, and the 100 comes up as well. Been such a good innings from Mark Dayal. He's striking at over 200. Roston Chase has joined him, and good after Fletcher really struggled to get going. 4 from 14.
It's his aggressive intent that has been so impressive throughout his entire CPL career. He's shown about 70% of attacking nature towards deliveries.
Yes, well ball, well ball. We don't mind that.
Well, it's almost that, dare I say it, with the history of TKR, it's that nothing to lose mentality, isn't it? I think most people would have had TKR as favourites coming into the game because of the history and the way they have dominated this competition so often. Not so much this year, but in the past. 10 from that over, 107 for 2. Start for the Kings has been exactly what they require. Bit of power to come in that batting order. Visa, David, Kimo Paul, Kadima Lean as well. And all strike the boundaries. So 9 overs to go. Themselves in a terrific position to post a very big score, 185, 190 minimum. I'd love to get more than that. Dream 11, I'm sure you've been online, downloaded the app, logged on to dream11.com. I'm sure Roston Chase has probably been a part of your team. If you picked Mark Dayal, well done to you. Well done to you. I had Ali Khan in mind. That was a bad selection, Simon.
Don't worry, it happens, Simon.
Kyron Pollard. A Lozak Road end. Push for 2. I don't think so. I don't think so. Just the one good call. Well, Mark Dayal, just enjoy a little bit of this. He's been brilliant. What a start he has had.
Simon, I mentioned that Karen Pollard is a patriarch of this TKR family. So if I was St. Lucia Kings, I'll be thinking about keeping him out of this game with ball, with bat. The less you can fuel his energy as a player, the better chance you can get above and over this TKR unit. It's a formidable unit. But when you look at what has happened throughout the league stage, he's been crucial in terms of their success. I'm also with the bat. St. Lucia Kings wouldn't want him to feature with the ball and add energy to his impending effort with the bat in the second half of this game.
Well, he certainly doesn't need the opposition to fire him up. His own teammates did that the other night by batting so ridiculously slowly. He came out, he was fuming.
In terms of strategy, you're trying to defeat the opponent, go to the head, take down the head.
Hero Hunk parked up nicely. Great to have Hero sponsors again. Has gone down towards third man. He's just taking pace off consistently here, Pollard, giving them absolutely nothing to work with.
Really must also amplify the innings that Rosslyn Chase has played so far, 19 from 13. He's just come in. He's happy to play classical strokes, turn the strike over, and support Mark Dale on the other end.
Oh, support. What about that? Just support that slower ball in the slot. Hero maximum. Oh, wasn't grumpy before, he just a little bit more now.
That's a stellar shot. An extension of his defense. Doesn't lose his shape. That's the essence of his batting success in this edition of Hero CPL.
Just thinking, a month and a bit, Kyron Pollard will be sitting sideline applauding that. As skipper of Rosslyn Chase, right now he doesn't want to see a bar of it. Wants nothing to do with it. Oh my goodness, that is even better. That is even better. What a shot that is to finish the over. I think that's gone all the way, Darren. We'll have a check.
Someone please call the dentist. I'm getting a cavity because of the sweetness of that stroke. We will wait for confirmation, but as gorgeous as you like from Rosslyn Chase over cover, that should be Hero Maximum. Yep, confirmation, 123 for two now.
What a great finish. Hero Maximum's race now. Rosslyn Chase 22. Look at the rest of that list and you think, yeah, power, a lot of power, but Chase has been such timing. Evan Lewis still well and truly at the top, 30. We'll see him later on today in the second semi-final, along with Nicholas Puran.
This is Akil Hussein, number 7, for his last over.
Yeah, we'll go head-to-head in today's second encounter.
123 for 2, 12 overs bowled.
Back-to-back Hero Maximums to finish the over. And that one there. Just enjoy. Watch. Enjoy. Let's have another replay. Fun 88 magic moment. Rosslyn. He's got his strike rate up over 200 now as well. Got to get back to Sunil Narayan, I think. They need a wicket. Pollard has got to go back to Narayan. He's not going to. He's going to Akil Hussain for his last. Got a man dead straight.
Oh, goodness me. I don't know whether that's an option.
Simon, the other thing I've noticed about St. Lucia Kings and why they're enjoying success in this innings is they know that TKR, they've been the leading wicket takers in that middle phase of the innings, over number 7 to over number 15. They've not allowed that to continue in this innings. They've kept their wicket takers out of this contest.
Would have been wide as well, but he's just got a little boot on that. It'll be a leg by.
So 31 wickets so far in this phase of the innings, and that's across the tournament. But the Kings, they've been really good in putting a damper on that strength of the Knight Riders. 50 partnership comes up.
There was a good chat between Roston Chase and Mark Dale after that first ball of the over as well. Just, I think, a little bit about settling down. No need for any real silly risks. I think it would have been about who possesses the most danger here. Narayan and Hussain probably possess the most danger to us at the moment. Let's not do anything silly against them. Getting big overs from the seamers and from the other end, so just settle.
That's why I felt that Karen Pollard could have brought Sunil Narayan back. Try to get a wicket. The only way you're going to control this batting from the Kings is by getting wickets. So bring your attacking bowler on, create pressure, try to get wickets in this middle phase. There's Sunil Narayan, only two overs so far. Pollard hasn't gone to that option, he's gone to himself.
Good. That's better from Mark Dayal. Even if this over only goes for 3 or 4, it actually doesn't matter. It means you've got 20 off the last two because you took 16 from Pollard's. Put them together. Don't worry about whether one is slightly smaller than the other. You're setting yourself up for a great back end of the innings. Bad one, try and put it away. Oh, brilliant, brilliant in the outfield. Guardian Life, save of the day, that is outstanding. Curry Pierre, 127 for 2. Right, Narayan is back for an over. Probably just one. Desperate for a breakthrough, and this is good cricket. Understand the moments in the game where you need to be a little more sensible.
Yeah, and Simon, I'm a little bit disappointed that the regional players here in the Caribbean, they have not mastered Sunil Narayan. He's been around for a long time. This is a ninth edition. Sunil Narayan with 11 wickets in the tournament. We've seen globally him reduce in terms of effectiveness as a wicket taker by players getting accustomed to him. I really want to see the regional players adopt that same sort of approach.
That's it!
Oh dear, oh dear. That is not smart from Mark Dayal. I'm sure that wasn't the plan. It's been a very good innings, but the reason that Sunil Narayan has come back into the attack has worked for the Knight Riders.
Quite rightfully so, he's disappointed. That's exactly what Kyron Pollard would have wanted in bringing back Sunil Narine at this stage of the innings. Being from Trinidad, he should know Sunil Narine. There shouldn't be any mystery there. Loses his wicket. Was that a match-winning innings? We'll wait and see. 128 for three.
Narine brought back into the attack to pick up a wicket, and he's done the job. Broken that partnership. No run there, no run there. Good work, Seifert.
Let me just qualify that statement that I made about Sunil Narine and him not being as effective internationally in terms of as a wicket taker. I think he's improved in his accuracy, but the mystery aspect of it, Caribbean players should be very familiar with what he does. The carambole, the conventional off break.
Catch it!
Just short. Can't get a run there either. Goodness me.
Yeah, just hiding the ball again. The mystery from this man. So over time, there should be more familiarity with what he does.
Oh, yes.
Well, what Tikau did do very well is they kept Mark Dayal quiet for the back end. 63 off his first 30 deliveries. Could only manage 15 off his next 14. They did a good job to keep him nice and quiet. This has been a brilliant over from Narine. A wicket and one run from Sunil Narine's over. Six to go, 128 for three. So far, six to go. 128 for three. Don't forget to download the Sports Max app if you're in the Caribbean. You can watch the CPL for free. Jump onto your relevant app store, get the Sports Max app, and watch the semi-finals and the final for free anywhere in the Caribbean. Curry Pierre. Two overs, just been a little bit expensive. That'll be a wicket. That'll be a wicket. It should be anyway. Oh my goodness me. Akhil Hussain. You've taken a blinder, you've just dropped the sitter.
Well, I just wish that you fans glued on could have seen the reaction from Captain Kyron Pollard, and that opportunity went down.
Oh, well, you have another one. Goodness me, Roston Chase, what are you doing? Keeper wants this one. Keeper takes it. back to back. It hasn't cost anything, and the reaction this time from Akil Hussain is very good.
And on the other end, Akil Hussain, he was already celebrating because Ramdin completed the catch, and which he did, means that his spilled chance costs his side nothing. Massive wicket for TKR. Chase goes for 36, 130 for four now.
Well, it's turned in the last eight deliveries. Brilliant over from Sunil Narine, wicket of Mark Dayal. And now TKR well and truly back in the game. Tim David is at the crease. So two big strikers at the crease. Carrie Pierre has come back nicely.
Admission accomplished to a large extent by Kyron Pollard and the TKRs. We've been talking about taking wickets in the middle phase of the innings to control this glut of runs from St. Lucia Kings. Well, they've done that. Narine getting the wicket of Dayal, and now Carrie Pierre getting the wicket of Roston Chase. Two new batsmen at the crease. Love this game, how it ebbs and flows, and the strategies, how they impact players.
Oh dear, brilliant from Seifert. Little mix up. Lucky for both, they were able to get back.
And a complete change in the tone from the Knight Riders. Evidence of it on show.
Tim David was a long way down. Sorry, Visa was a long way down.
Got him now, easy run out.
Almost paid for it. Well, Predictviz says 184 now. It was up over 200 at one stage. Another very good over for Trinbago Knight Riders. End of 15, it is 133 for four.
One for 10 from his three into his last over. There's a little bit of extra spice in this contest. If you throw your minds back, those of you who were with us for the final of 2020, there's a little bit of beef at the way some celebrations went at the end of the contest. So that has added a little bit of spice to this return match, Samuel Badri. I know that the franchise from St. Lucia felt a little hard done by after the final.
Yeah, Thompson. Yeah, you got him now. Come on.
This has been exceptional from the Trinbago Knight Riders. The last 30 balls, 28 runs, 2 wickets. So they've pulled things back quite nicely. And Kanda Davids slay Goliath here today in this semi-final. Tim David, David Visa up against the Juggernaut, which is the Trinbago Knight Riders in CPL.
One.
Kimo Paul in that pre-match interview did mention a grudge match, like you mentioned there, Bish. So much history between these two teams. Of course, Darren Sammy, Karen Pollard, two revered players in these parts. Darren Sammy, of course, was captain last year, mentor this year.
Ravi Rampol has a couple of overs left. Carrie Pierre has 135 for 4. So far in Hero CPL, Akil Hussain, 144, Sunil Narayan, one behind him. Imran Tahir has been outstanding. Hopefully we get to see him in semi-final number 2. Ravi Rampol on the list as well as Al-Zahri. And it's Rampol who is back.
Central the semi-final, enjoying themselves. And from what we've seen so far, promises to be a really electric game. Rampol has been electric in this tournament. A bit expensive today, 22 runs from his two. And looking to close off things for the Knight Riders. Two powerful strikers of the cricket ball for the Kings at the crease. And they too will be looking to finish strongly. So the next 4 overs can be swashbuckling action.
Fascinating field. 2 fielders at point. One just behind point saving one. One just in front of point. In addition to a deep wide third man, deep extra cover long off. Circle those point fielders. Had a fascinating conversation with one of the hotel employees last night, and they were saying, walked in to the store, and one person asked, Mr. Bishop, what is a long on and what is a long off? Where is that? I said, well, try to describe to her down the ground where those positions were. And she then put me in a tough position where she said, sometimes when I'm at work, I can't watch the television, but I'm listening. That's long on and long off. Straight to one of those square fielders. I can't watch the game, the person was saying, but I'm listening to the commentary because I love the game. But there's only so much we can do in terms of our explanation. But the big point is there are new viewers coming in all the time who need to get a better understanding of the fundamentals of the game and more explanation.
That's it.
That's a lovely slash. All the way for a hero maximum. Over backward point.
Well, it's the area that Ravi Rampol wanted him to score. He wants him to score square off the wicket, just not over the boundary for six. So it was a good shot from David Visa. Important blow, important strike at this stage. What this edition of the Hero CPL has done here at Warner Park, it has forced bowlers to bowl wide and full, even if that wasn't their usual modus operandi. Because of the dimensions on offer and the conditions here, many of the bowlers have opted for this plan. And just a reminder, we are the most easterly of the pitches. That's the dimensions there. 59 square, but into the wind. So still, bowlers are opting for that line. After that six, things may change for Ravi Rampol and Karan Pollard.
Field remains the same. It'll be interesting to see if he goes fuller in length. Magnificent. Gigantic strike. I think Bosch doesn't do it justice.
And because of that six in the previous ball, Ravi Rampol felt that he had to bowl a closer line, a tighter line. And so I just felt that he moved away from the plan. And he's paid the ultimate price. Consecutive sixes for David Visa. The plan is wide. He'll need to revert to that. Might be a change in field now. There is. So that point in the boundary comes to the inner circle. Fine leg goes squarer, and a short fine leg comes into position. So will be bowling a straighter line, but much fuller now from Rampol.
Ali Khan returned to the field some time ago and has confirmed that it is a thigh strain. Very good. From Darren Bravo. Guardian Life save of the day. 150 up, 150 for four.
I'm trying to go for another hero maximum. Had two in the over already. David Visa, not as much of a connection, but a good stop.
The score 150.
Manages to hold that one back in. The M Bravo. And some good high towers for the Kings throughout this innings.
And our team is going from the southern end as well. This is Carrie Pierre for a swap ends.
Couple of nice towers there. Not so much around Warner Park. Let's go out and about.
Hey guys, we are at the Republic Bank. Boston! So tell me, who is your most valuable player and why?
You'd be surprised, but Dwayne Varro is my most valuable player. Simply because he has chosen to impart his skill, knowledge and experience to the younger players rather than take up a space on the side and deny a younger player what's happening right now in the West Indies cricket. So good luck to him and to the Patriots.
All right, thank you. Republic Bank fans, that we in this together!
That's gone to muscular blows from Tim David and David Visa.
This is what he has done really well in 2021. Tim David, at the back end of an innings, he's able to score significantly. Too short and pummeled down the ground. Starts the over with a six, pressure on Caripe immediately.
Another six, back-to-back strikes into the wind from Tim David.
And many of you would remember, Tim David started off this season with a half century on debut, playing shots like these. Such a fearless cricketer. And he wants to be a renowned finisher. Well, he's augmenting that reputation as we speak. Two sixes. Predict Viz 185.
There's a challenge here for TKR as well with the injury to Ali Khan. We don't know whether he will be available to bowl again. Only bowled two overs. Kyron Pollard bowled one. Sunil Narine, of course, was bowled out a touch earlier because of all the aggression shown by the Kings. So Ravi Rampol has one left. And they need to find another over from somewhere. Would it be Kyron Pollard?
Harry.
Three in a row. That is a magnificent strike. Pierre tried to push him wider, fuller, and faster.
Maybe looking to get him to cut, maybe looking to go full. Any event, it goes over the boundary. David goes at 151, a strike rate of 151 against spin. And this is the reason why. His ability to hit sixes across the ground, not only through the onside, but as you've just seen there, through the offside. So his versatility is allowing him to do this. Three sixes and three balls.
Just seen Ali Khan stretching. I don't know what that means. A moment ago, into his feet. That piece of advice came from Akhil Hussain, good friend of Caripe, to come over the wicket and try to bowl full and into his feet. Miss hit into the gap. Couple more runs.
Keep going, keep going.
This has been a really good over for the Kings. 20 coming off it so far. One delivery left.
Well bowled, Carey.
Very good. In the second half of the over, Ali Khan has been loosening up, might have a bowl. 18 overs gone, 171 for four.
Expensive spell from Caripe, one for 51 from his four. Haven't seen him going for so many so often in his CPL career.
Biggest over of the innings, that last one. Three consecutive sixes to start it off.
Long on, square leg, long off. Dynamism of the man.
Lifebuoy hand washing station These stations have become a feature in these pandemic times. Reload again. Instructive to see where Tim David is standing before the bowler delivers.
And he's reverted to this plan, this wide plan, full and wide. Always a little bit risky with pace on. Visal hit him for six over point. What can Tim David do?
Nice shot for one.
Good, okay.
Such a fine margin for error at this stage of the innings. Wonderful vantage point at this facility. But if you're slightly off against these two, against anyone really at this stage of the innings, you can travel the distance, especially given the short straight boundaries.
That's a shot. And it finds the gap with precision.
I was just mentioning how risky it is with pace on and wide. It bisects the two fielders. And no protection behind them. Now there's another change in field. A reinforcement on the point boundary. Just a solitary fielder on the onside on the boundary, Karen Pollard himself at long on. So maybe just look to walk across and get the leg side now.
No wide this time because Visa had moved across outside the off stump before the ball was released, even though it was outside of the blue guideline.
So there is a predictability of line, certainly now, without question. Because of the field that he has set, he has to bowl wide. He has to bowl just inside that wide line, just outside, depending on how far the batsman moves.
Six more. 50 partnership of just 27 deliveries missing the El Dorado barrel.
Say that with some disappointment, Ian Bishop. But I like this from David Visa. Even though the option is leg side with the field, he's backing his ability to hit over the offside for six. Many other batsmen might have thought leg side, but he's still going offside. Look how close this goes to the barrel. Not too far off. Not too far from Darren Bravo as well.
And Pollard has gone where Darren Bravo was, a taller fielder. And too wide, says the umpire. And that's instructive. Because the line is full and wide and the high traffic areas are offside, Bravo was just considered by Pollard vertically challenged, so he's replaced him. Still see Ali Khan stretching down there, so maybe they might try to get an over out of him. That's gone for six as well. This is good ball striking from start to finish for the St. Lucia Kings.
And pace on again. It's always going to be risky with pace on and wide, like I mentioned before. Again, David Visa gets the gap and gets another six. This has been brutal. 62 runs coming in the last 30 deliveries. A wonderful end so far.
Yeah, I hear what you're saying about pace on. It's just the Yorkers he's missing. 190 for four.
This this is a really good score. Make no mistakes about it. 190 with an over to go. Started with that partnership, Fletcher and DL, and has just continued. This one, 60 of 30.
Run partnership coming at two runs a ball between Visa and Tim David. Dali Khan has ball in hand. Left the field with a thigh strain earlier. Usually what he tries to do with a low slingy action, lower than many, is to go full, go Yorker. It's an interesting delivery that, because it's full and wide, pace on, but there's no deep point or deep third man. Two deep fielders on the offside are in front of square, so that's quite risky as you look at the left side of that graphic. The offside circle there is the deep extra cover to the bottom of the screen, long off, but there's no one top of the screen out on the boundary.
Just a quick change of gloves for Tim David. These two batsmen have long levers and good reach. So whilst those wide deliveries would work better for some shorter batsmen, they aren't for these two.
That's what Pollard would have come up and said to Ali Khan a little while ago. You can go full, you can go to your Yorker, but go straight, not wide. Bowl to the field. Very good so far in the over anyway.
I just feel if they can manage to restrict the St. Lucia Kings for under 200, psychologically will feel a little bit better. On the other hand, if they can get past 200, the Kings, they would be boosted. We've had a few teams getting past that 200 mark. St. Lucia Kings, one of the two teams to do that this season. Got 224, I think, when Faf du Plessis scored that century.
Very good. Very good from Ali Khan. Two taken. And I think the difference between himself and Rampol so far anyways, he's hitting his Yorkers, whatever the line. Could hear Dinesh Ramdin saying, well, ball Ali.
Excellent running as well between these two. Taking every opportunity. Every run counts in the end. We all know how this game can end, how close it can end. So every run, every single available, ensure that you take them. Bowlers getting ready. Alzari Joseph will be quite crucial in defense of whatever score they get.
Don't miss your length here. Don't miss your length. Missed his length. And even though it was the tall Pollard, 6'5", he could not extend and pull it in. 200 comes up.
And 16 sixes in this innings for the St. Lucia King. Goes up, up. Not enough from Karen Pollard. If he can't get that, no one can. But it just goes to show margin for error with those Yorkers. Very, very minimal. Have to absolutely nail them. Wonderful score for the St. Lucia Kings. Semi-final, big match. Runs on the board.
Don't miss your length again. Another life boy clean strike, and Tim David wants a new bat that perhaps came off the toe of the bat.
This Tim David is some player, isn't he? To do what he's done and what he continues to do, finishing off innings, always says that he wants to be a world-class finisher. Low full toss in the end, but getting just enough on it to go to the boundary. One bounce. And final delivery.
Can he get the Yorker right to finish the innings? No, he bowls length, gets away with it. That could have gone many places. But an outstanding effort with the bat in this semi-final number one by the St. Lucia Kings. 205 for four. It will require some run chase to overhaul this for the defending champions.
Alzari Joseph with the ball.
Gentlemen, let's play.
Rakim Cornwall in it slip, so a slip in place and Simmons on strike. Chase about to start. Top edge, away to the boundary for four. First off, some luck for Lendl Simmons.
Lucky Lendl. Yeah, no surprises, he's going to have a swipe. His go-to strokes. Does love a hook and a pull. And often so good there. Extra pace on. So you have to be very careful here, Alzari Joseph. Again, you want to start so well as a fielding side. Can they get a wicket early? Or can they halt the flow of runs inside the power play?
That's better.
Yeah, it's been good in terms of back end of a length. I think with the new seed, Alzari Joseph, that is, when he's been into the surface and just a little bit of movement, gets that angle back into right-handers off the seam. Sometimes a little hint of shape. But it's more about off the surface. And there's been a bit of that. But this is different. This is such a good pitch now for the playoffs.
And again.
I was out there with Darren Ganger and talking with ground staff. And they've had the triple headers. But they played there already. And then we moved across during the tournament a few days ago. And then we've gone back to here, and you can see that the ground staff have enjoyed this. As it's the most consistent of the three. So hard-working gentlemen, well done. Having some Angostura chill moments and refreshers.
Yeah, they do a great job, mind you. If you were going to be anywhere working, Danny, wouldn't be bad, would it?
Or not working.
Beautiful, St. Kitts and Nevis. Great hosts. I mean, it's been amazing. Have you ever done a cruise? Have you been on one of those?
No, not allowed.
Not allowed?
Yeah, anyone under 6 feet. Not letting us on.
Yeah. So I've always thought about it, but then I thought, well, it's an over 50s thing. So now I'm sort of eligible. A little bit of cheek from the back of the commentary box saying I could have gone a couple of years ago.
Ages ago. But, in all seriousness, beautiful, as you say, Dooley. We've been blessed and truly grateful to come here in the last sort of 6 or 7 years for the Hero CPL. And even in these tough pandemic times, we're still back here. So, hashtag grateful.
Yeah, spot on. And everything and everyone that's made this possible is... done such a good job. Right from the very top all the way down, the organisation and the preparation that goes into this tournament is exceptional. Our major sponsors, Hero, their hunk on screen. It's been a privilege to be back and watch some fantastic cricket. Wide. Tough times when it's all in one venue, but everybody's played their part and done their job. Been exceptional.
Yeah, I just want to throw out there. Interesting here, this runs on the board, but should TKR lose, should they lose, there'd be a new winner on the trophy. Hmm.
Oh, yes, a little edge there. Lendl Simmons gone early. Big breakthrough for the Kings.
Eldorado celebration time. Let's get the ice involved and cut loose. They sure are here, those in blue. Now, a little scrambled seam, but he's tried something a bit cute here. He's wanted to go onside when the ball's been way outside off. Alzari Joseph celebrates with his Kings teammates. First one down early. Lendl goes for just four. It's 6-for-1 now.
New incoming batsman number 82, Colin Munro. Team score 6 for the loss of 1 wicket. Wahab Riaz. Number 47, he'll be bowling from northern end, southern end, Mazakro.
Colin Munro out inside the power play. I think this is his best place. I know he'd rather open the batting. His record this year hasn't been as good as far as that strike rate is concerned. His prowess as a T20 player at the international level came at the top of the order. Strike rate of 165, two international hundreds, 850s, opening the batting. Just wonder whether today might be his day, or I've just put the curse on him and he'll nick off early. Narine, is that bat or pad? Pad, leg by, giving himself room straight away, and Wahab looking to follow him.
He's so good with the wrists, as we all know, Lendl Simmons, and he can invent strokes for the onside, but this was a little bit too ambitious early on. And they're not ideal, given that he'd also just got a top edge for four, so didn't really have to go and make something out of that. Cost the team and him dearly.
Just over the offside. Should be a couple. Favours that offside, Senil Narine. He'll look to give himself some room, leg side. He can get trapped into bowling at the stumps, and that's what he wants you to do. Your options for Narine are either go wide of off stump. He's more of a chance of nicking it off. I'd like to see a more of a third man back in place, or you're going to have Alzari Joseph there. Get him in at another slip. Put a two and a four in there. Perhaps. That'll be wide. Wahab losing control there.
Yeah, I hear the strategy, Dooley. I like the other one too, where, particularly for Wahab, when he's up against Narine, he could actually just go wide on the crease and angle it at him and make him feel very uncomfortable and try and, put a brooch on his chest. Just pin the ball to the chest.
Yeah, and that way you put a deep square leg back and then you put fine leg back as well, I think. Fine leg and deep square and have everything angled in at leg stump. It'll change around a little bit for Munro. You can look at the two boundary riders there. Deep backward point and deep backward square for Colin Munro. He's got enough time here. I know it's a big chase, but he's got enough time to just have a look for a few deliveries and figure things out. Oh, the mid-wicket. We might pick up a boundary straight away. Life boy clean strike for Colin Munro.
Yeah, another go-to region for the left-hand of Munro. Ah, indeed. Keep it clean. He does.
It's straight. And that's the trouble you can get with Colin Munro. You think you've got him, you think you'll wrap those pads, but he whips it away leg side. Just got to hold his shape. It's the key for Colin Munro.
Yeah, and the other thing, I suppose, in the repertoire of Wahab is that you can be brave enough to bowl a really good change-up. He bowls those knuckleballs and the ones out of the front of the hand that just never arrive. And so you got that up your sleeve, as it were, and then you could have the batter trying to get that onside, the bigger side attracted, and the ball can be a top edge and go straight up. Or you get through the shot too early and maybe knock the poles over.
Too wide. Radar gone wrong, Wahab.
We'll do that. Yeah. And that shows you again, the bowlers have had a bit of a say, hence the strike rates we showed you just moments ago. Striking, well, 99. Run a ball stuff for Munro, which is unlike him, but the surfaces have been so that it's been difficult. And I don't think that's been a bad thing. Batters have had to work hard and haven't had it all their own way, where it's just been lovely and flat and you can hit through the line. So it's been fascinating. It's been a really interesting tournament, season 9 here in St. Kitts and Nevis, given the pitches we've had.
Well, I think it's been great, Danny. And I know what we've just talked about with the pandemic and people unable to get here at times, certain overseas players changing late, changing at last minute. We've seen some really good performances from those that have come in. We've seen some emerging stars, some emerging talent in the West Indies region come through and shine. Some old timers, some old stages have put on good performances. Been a little bit for everyone. Oh, yes, please. Yes, please, Colin. Half a dozen. Hero maximum to end the second, 25 for one.
Yeah, crisp from Colin. It was in the slot area that Munro so enjoys and thrives on. Been on about it, Dooley needs to bat up the order, and he's got an opportunity because of Lendl getting out after six balls. If you're slightly off, look out.
Loves that area of the ground, the leg side, but you get a little bit wide, he'll punish you through the offside as well. Zari Joseph picked up a wicket in his first. He's got another. One for six. And the Ryan on strike. There's that room. That's the Hero X Pulse on screen there. Hugely popular in the Indian market. You see hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of those on a daily basis. The X Pulse. Probably thousands and thousands, to be honest with you, on a daily basis. Great riding the streets of India.
Swung away leg side. There is a man out there. Should just be the one at will.
Yeah, Mark Daly's at a good time of it. First half anyway. Just wanted to tell you, he's an option. Bells is a Loffies. Feeling good about things. Often helps you do one of your strings to your bow well and it can flow on. Let's see how Joseph pans up here. Still at field here of the square sides, leg and off, covering the cut and that pull side.
Nice line, tight in and around that off stump. Wahab Briez, what's he thinking after a tough first over?
I find it a risky field too there, given that he's bowling with the breeze over his left shoulder, Alzari, and paced across the lefties and no third man. And it's sliding across there into the pitch as he does.
The offside, and that'll race away for four. One bounce. As I said, you think he's leg side predominantly, but you give him a little bit of room, he'll find the offside boundary as well.
Yeah, delightful. Munro. So you saw it at the international level. Six overs, the power play up and over, and so good there. And Warner, well, no price.
That field change, so now he's got to be tight. He's got to be in at the hips of Munro here. Watch Munro just maybe try and swivel if he gets a little bit short. Swivel and get it very fine. Yeah. Tight lines here. I don't know what the little shrug of the arms and shoulders was for there from Alzari Joseph towards the keeper, the captain.
Yeah, because it wasn't bad. Hello, he's not happy about something because Fletch, as we know, keeper captain, standing in the Faf. Quick chat. He's got the fields. He's getting a full rev here from the skipper. Quite a lengthy discussion here.
Just have a look at this. Watch after the ball. Wait, and have a look. Have a look there. There, just a little gesture straight to Andre Fletcher. Yeah, and he's going to just settle down. It's okay. That ensued a little chat.
Well, he's got that packed offside field, went straight to a fielder. Like he could argue maybe a fraction full, but not bad.
And again straight to the man. It's okay, three gone, 30 for one. The wicket of Lendl Simmons early. Sitting on the Ryan. Three or four. He hasn't had a good tournament with the bat at the top of the order, Sitting on the Ryan. Strike rate of just 94 when opening in this CPL. It's the lowest he's ever recorded in a T20 tournament opening the batting. When he's faced more than 50 deliveries, that is. So it's a fair sample size. Change now, Roston Chase. Two left-handers at the crease, understandable.
Yeah, Wahab disappearing for 15. Given though his stats there, 37% of his deliveries in all T20s come in that opening stage because he gets the new ball to do a bit.
Oh, edge. Chase for Joseph. Can he get there? The big long arms, long limbs. Yes, he can.
Once again, underlines your flexibility as a team. You just have to have that variety. Off goes Wahab. And you've got two lefties. Bit of offspin going away, so yeah, good move. Making Sunil come at you. Go after the bowling.
Yes.
Oh, he has the option of Rakim Cornwall as well if he wants to throw another off-spin option. I don't mind that, actually, at the two left-handers. He's only bowled a couple of overs in the tournament. Lays back and laces it down straight at the camera. Don't duck. Riff, what are you doing, boy? Get it, stay in line. Get the shot.
Get your hands on it, Chief. Come on. Not painted on. We'll get a helmet on as well, just quietly. It's come nice and flattish. Just too short from Chase, but look at this. Oh, duck for cover. Expensive, those cameras.
What was he looking at there? He was looking at the dugout, I think. Not even watching the game, Riv. Come on. And again, short, punished into the leg side. Four more.
Yeah, it's almost like having throwdowns for Soon on the Ryan. These last two, Roston Chase has missed his length quite badly. It's too easy. Far too easy for Soon on the Ryan. These are freebies inside the six overs.
There's a chat just there between Fletcher and Rakim Cornwall. I wonder whether that was around, do you feel like bowling the next over or not? Oh, nice. I like it. It'll be wide. But Narayan had the presence of mind to actually just say, no, I'll leave it alone. I'll get back into my crease. So it was good from him as well.
Yeah, because of course you can be stumped off a wide if he'd sort of lost it completely, but no. Yeah.
Oh, dear. Mark Dayal. Good day with the bat. Forgot the hands in the field.
Yeah. You won't want to look at the replay on the big screen. Mark Dayal. Oh, dear. Keep working, lads.
Do we give him a bad bounce there? Do we?
No.
Okay. Harsh. Great start. TKR flying along. Wahab Riaz by one expensive over for 15. He's changed ends. He's back to our commentary box end. Bowling with a deep square leg and a deep mid wicket. Oh dear, there's a run there. There's a run there all day, every day. Narayan not interested. Right, make your Dream 11 team. I'm sure you've been on the app or logged on to dream11.com. Hopefully you may have had Mark Dayal in there today. Cash and prizes. Oh,
Oh dear.
You've seen it over the years with Wahab. He does it. He sort of often has to. He gets sort of stuck with his planting foot, his front foot. When he lands, he's just not quite happy with it. He's notorious for no balls in white ball cricket. He just slides, and then if he just when he plant, yeah. Interesting. Nothing really in it there.
Mostly bold, tucks him up well.
Yeah, I think it's a good move. You get back into Wahab with a new ball and left-handers at the crease, and he gets it right there with just a little bit of shape. And if he wants to bang it in and bomb someone like Sunil on the right, I don't think it's a bad thing either. Set the field accordingly, as we were saying, Dooley, and get it up and close down an angle and chase him so he can't free those arms and make life really uncomfortable. Hence the two men on the leg side there with a QT graphic.
You can't bowl there, Wahab, not with that field. That has gone all the way for a hero maximum. Loose. Good from the Ryan, though.
Won't please Fletcher, captain and keeper, down the barrel. He's loving it. Yeah, Calypso, that's right where he wants it. It's almost, once again, like throwdowns. Give me one that's a little wide and in my arc. Please. Wahab.
Well, he's got to either get the Yorker in at leg stump or be short and in at the body. It's better. Well fielded. A little bit leg side, though.
Oh, yeah, he's got away with this because it's just that length where you do. You just paddle it around the corner and use the pace of the bowler. So, yeah, lucky there. So he's gone for seven. He needs to finish this over here. 50's up. And there's still two deliveries to go. Oh. Well, so getting in towards the end of the power play, and you get someone like a David Visa to cutters and changing it up. He's had a good time with the bat. Does that flow on into his bowling? Kings will be hoping soon.
That's better. Cramping him for room. Just the one. There he is, David Visa. That partnership with Tim David was superb.
He's getting all excited with all sorts of songs and tunes, titles around Mr. Visa. Yes. Let's see what he can do. Tim David, the other overseas play, good time of it. In fact, they put on 75 and 37 with that partnership. Last four overs going for 70. So it's allowed the Kings to breach 200. Let's see if they can squeeze it and defend it.
Oh, Wahab. That line wrong. This is not a good start from the international overseas player. Expect more.
Yeah, he's almost bowled two, but he's gone for 24. It's not like he's got a wicket or two next to his name. Just Alzari Joseph so far with a wicket.
Room and through the gap. That'll race away, I think, or no. Just might pull it in. Tim David. Just. Oh, dear. Took out one of his teammates as well. Anyway, end of the fifth, 57 for one.
Partnership between Colin Munro and Sunil Narine in 28 balls with 5 fours and 2 maximums. Team score 57 for the loss of 1 wicket. Colin Munro on 18, Sunil Narine on 24. Trinbago Knight Riders needs 206 runs to win the game.
last ball of the previous over. Tim David in pursuit, pulls it back in, but almost takes out one of his teammates. Might have been Kashrick Williams jumping out of the way. It's been a good start by the Trinbago Knight Riders. Five overs gone, 57 for one. In partnership 51 of just 28 deliveries. 24 and 18 respective contributions. New bowler into the attack, David Visa. A five-wicket haul earlier in the tournament. Change-ups, variations. The last over of the power play. In the gap, and starts with a boundary. Colin Munro. So they really want to capitalize on this final over, Darren Ganga.
Indeed, terrific shot by Colin Munro. Significantly, his strike rate, 183. Ideal tempo to his innings. Ideal tempo to this partnership between himself and Sunil Narine. 55 from 29.
Yeah, pace off from Visa. Colin Munro throughout this season has had a comparatively low strike rate. So often used to see him scoring quite quickly for the Trinbago Knight Riders, but because his strike rate has been much lower this season, today he has no choice but to go after the bowling.
The other thing too, Samuel Badri, when you look at the TKR's batting in this tournament, they're batting in the power play overs and the middle overs in terms of runs per over, the worst across all teams, 6.2 and 7 respectively. And a lot of that has to do with Colin Munro and what he produced with the bat so far before this innings, 239 runs with a strike rate of just 99. So he will have to take personal responsibility for what they've achieved previously. So far, he's done a brilliant job in transforming his game and striking 157. Real difference.
Andrew Fletcher up to the stumps now for David Visa. Previous delivery, Colin Munro advancing. So just to keep him in his crease, keeping him honest.
And the other thing about this TKR batting, amongst the persons with 50 plus runs, only two batsmen have a strike rate in excess of 120. That's previous to this game. Those two batsmen, Akhil Hussain and Karan Pollard. So collectively, TKR, in terms of strike rates, very, very low in the context of T20 cricket.
Yeah, and they've still managed to top the table. Managed to end the number one team after the group stage. So they've done what it took to get there.
Having said that, I feel this target score is the ideal impetus for this TKR batting unit. They've got a bat with a greater energy, a greater purpose. That might well work in their favor for this run chase.
In the gap again, and Sunil Narine. Six overs gone, 66 for one.
For the loss of one wicket. Colin Munro on 23, Sunil Narine on 28. Trinbago Knight Riders needs 140 runs from 14 overs. Wickets in hand, 9.
The best power play score for the Trinbago Knight Riders in this edition of the Hero CPL. Previously 50 for 2. Guardian Life power play against the Guyana Amazon Warriors. So really good start, and they needed that start in pursuit of this magnificent score set by the Kings. Narine just playing his hands through the offside and getting the gap, and that's what you're going to get from Narine. He's going to come at you even outside the power play. More fielders outside now. Let's see how they go. Ruston Chase switches ends from the pavilion end now. Colin Monroe has to bat deep. He has to bat the majority of overs in this chase. He's such an integral part of this team. Sunil Narine will continue to bat the way Sunil Narine bats.
Well, I mentioned in the first half of the game, Sunil Narine and his lack of effectiveness as a wicket taker in T20 cricket over the years. But what he has done is he's transformed himself into a batsman at the top of the order, or maybe in the middle, that can power the ball. His average opening the batting is 17.2 with a strike rate of 149. So he's probably transferred some of his energy from his bowling to his batting to give him those numbers. Really good job by him.
Back up.
Yeah, we talk about evolution as a player and continuing to improve on your skill set. And that's one way to do it.
We know of his challenges with his action as well. That's not an easy thing for a bowler to deal with. Psychologically, it's very challenging.
St. Lucia Kings will be looking for wickets just to control this middle period. It's such a big game. Semi-final number one, winner goes through. And both these teams were in the finals last time around, so one will repeat, at least getting there.
Got it.
In there, dropped it. Misjudgment from David Visa. That should have been taken. Circling, going in, and at the last moment just fell over his head.
Spot on. He moved forward when he should have been running aside to the ball, knowing that that's going with the wind. So it's always going to finish further from you.
And that's the opportunity they were looking for. The Kings and Ruston Chase against the left-hand batsmen. Fletcher, captain in this contest. Final delivery from Chase is over.
Yes. Back up.
Quiet over. Just 5 runs coming off it. 71 for one. Lucia Kings getting a healthy target of 205 for 4 of the allotment. Dial stands out. And 71 for 1. The Knight Riders in pursuit, so their run rate over 10 at the moment. So in touching distance of the required rate. The issue is whether they can maintain that through the middle overs. In the last over, only 5 runs. lots of communication between captain and bowler just to get the strategies right. Not in the 11 today, Samit Patel. They've got Javor Royal, the left-hand orthodox, who usually opens the bowling. But because of Narayan and the left-handedness of the two players at the crease, we haven't seen him just yet. Another option might be Rakim Cornwall if these two continue to be at the crease. And for the moment, David Visa will continue.
More behind, more behind.
Might be five wides. Andrew Fletcher up to the stump to keep Monroe in his crease, but it has backfired. A wayward delivery and three runs for Trinbago Knight Riders.
Runs flowing at the moment for the Knight Riders. Not a good sign for St. Lucia Kings. There's another significant reason why you can't rule the Knight Riders out of this run chase. Has to do with the Kings and their bowling in the debt overs. Yes. Debt over bowling, a massive concern for the St. Lucia Kings because they concede the most across all teams throughout this tournament. 11.6. That's what their bowlers go for in the last five overs. So Karen Pollard and the Knight Riders will know if they can get to that 15th over mark. They're in with a chance based on the trend that we've seen from the Kings with the ball in the last five.
Catch it.
In there,
catch
it. Who wants it? Fielders coming in and taken. Republic Bank Classic. David Visa gets his revenge. Kadeem Aline in the team for today completes the catch. A good catch. Narayan has to go.
The Kings have just broken a 71 run partnership. 71 off just 43. That's significant. The confidence you saw from Kadeem Aline running for that catch, you knew he was going to take it, and he did so. Narayan goes for well played innings of 30. 77 for 2.
Bowled by David Weeds, caught by Kadeem Ali. New incoming batsman, number 80, Dinesh Ramdin.
Important wicket for the St. Lucia Kings. A good partnership between Narayan and Munro. 30 from 17, Narayan. So he did his job. Dinesh Ramdin, the new batsman to the crease. Quick single. Darren Ganga, Dinesh Ramdin, your thoughts?
Thanks for that question, Samuel Badri. That's the wicket of Sunil Narayan. I guess they've been priming Dinesh Ramdin to bat higher in the order to maintain a left-hand, right-hand combination. I'd like to see West Indies specialist T20 batsman who was picked for the World Cup team, DM Bravo, make a significant contribution, but I understand the left-hand, right-hand combination. Bravo, of course, in the reserves for that team.
Good work from Andrew Fletcher, who is the backup wicketkeeper in that squad that you just mentioned, Darren Bravo, as a traveling reserve. Also, there's Tim Seifert, another right-hander who,
going, guys,
very pugnacious. really good strike rate in this tournament. Pollard himself. Let's just think that maybe one of either two of them, if you want to have that right-left combination, should have come. It's a pitch that you still need to have some time before you can go. I know that Pollard can come and go immediately. He has done that time and time again. Seifert has done that too in this tournament. Ramden needs to know his role. And his role should be to get at minimum a runner ball. Turn the strike over, run hard between the wickets. Cannot afford to soak up dot deliveries. Very experienced player, and he will know exactly what is required of him.
Well, he can't play innings like the last one in match number 30 when he batted against the Patriots at the top of the order. Scored 17 from 23. That's not the tempo required today.
70-30 at the moment. Bowled him. A double wicket strike for David Visa, just dragging it onto his stumps, Colin Munro. And you can hear the expression from Andrew Fletcher on what it means to the Kings.
Very unfortunate for Munro, playing on to his pad, then onto the stumps. As soft as you would like. But on the other hand, a loud celebration from St. Lucia Kings. Munro goes for 28, 80 for 3.
Wicket number 3 goes for Trinbago Knight Riders, Colin Munro. Power for 28, bowled by David Lee. New incoming batsman, number 46, Darren Rao. New bowler, number 12, Jawar Royal. He'll be bowling from Northern End Media Center.
Team score. Double wicket strike in the last over for David Visa. Darren Bravo, the new batsman for the Trinbago Knight Riders. Struggled throughout this edition of the Hero CPL. Jawar Royal, new bowler for the Kings. The first time we'll be seeing him today. Has 12 wickets in the tournament so far, Royal. The economy of 6.75, so a stellar tournament for him.
Keep going.
Two new batsmen at the crease, the best time to come on to bowl. Just maybe thought an over of Alzari, perhaps, as Darren Bravo at the crease. Might have been an option for Fletcher. Or even Wahab Riaz. As it is, the left-hand orthodox to the left-handed Bravo. Yeah, innocuous delivery, off-cutter.
Yeah.
Bat pads onto the stumps. Emotion, unbridled joy, El Dorado celebration.
Keep going.
Protection in the deep. Wants two, wants the strike, gets it. So, signaling his intention immediately.
And that's very good. Darren Bravo at the crease because of this dismissal. Colin Munro. But he will want to prove a couple points. Darren Bravo, one, that he is a match winner and he can take the TKRs over the line in this run chase. But secondly, wouldn't want to fuel that debate about him being on a West Indies World Cup reserve list as the best specialist T20 batsman.
wrong line. And too easy for Darren Bravo. So a good start for him.
Superb hitting with the turn. Importance of a left-hand, right-hand combination at the crease for the Knight Riders. So crucial, especially against the spinners and the fast bowlers. Always need to shift your line, change your strategy with the change in batsman.
Yeah, just feel that Fletcher missed a trick here by not introducing Wahab or Alzari for just one over. Try to get Bravo out. This matchup favors Darren Bravo, and so far it's bearing fruit. And again, six this time. So an exceptional start for DM Bravo against a matchup that he favors.
And he loves playing spinners. Bravo, his obvious strength, his ability to use his feet, that beautiful swing that he has as a left-handed batsman. So synonymous with the great Brian Charles Lara.
Seen some quick bowling in this match. FedEx fastest deliveries of this contest, Alzari Joseph, features prominently there. As a matter of fact, features all by himself. Might have been an option for Fletcher. I remember one game that Faf du Plessis didn't use Jevo Royal at all. Opted for Kimo Paul.
That's it, that's your strength, that's your strength.
Smart batting, sensible from Bravo. He's gotten 13 in the over before that ball. A single makes it 14. 94 for three. A single from Dinesh Ramlin just to close things off, and sensible batting from these two.
That's it, that's it.
15 from the over, 95 for three. Riders just creating some room and a gap with the yellow worm of the St. Lucia Kings. Ruston Chase will replace David Visa after that double wicket strike.
Changing bowler, Ruston Chase, he'll be bowling from southern end.
Almost at the halfway mark of the Knight Riders chase, so you just want to maybe get through this over without the loss of any further wickets, have a conversation and reset themselves with that target in the last 10.
Keep using it, sir. Yeah, yeah. Back up.
Single.
Back up.
Well, the Trinbago Knight Riders team will want to prove itself as a real champion team, because in sport, they say, you aren't a real champion if you're able to defend your title successfully. Madri is the real champion in this team, or is the real champion at the Patriots, controlling things for the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots?
Squeeze, Wab.
Dwayne Bravo.
Squeeze.
Well, he'll have an opportunity a little bit later on to get his team to the finals when they come up against the Guyana Amazon Warriors. I just feel that they'll just look to get through this over, maybe six, seven runs, if the boundary opportunity presents itself, yes, but after this over, they'll have a quick chat and just reassess and reset themselves for that final boost. Likes of Seifert and Pollard in the sheds.
Will Bravo be searching for a boundary against Roston Cheese? Cheese taking the ball away from the left-hander. Should it have been Ramdin's responsibility to hit with the turn and get that early boundary?
Yes.
Excellent fielding. Mark Dale misfielded one earlier in the game, but he's made a reprieve.
Sweetly timed, just lacking placement there from Darren Bravo. Looks quite fluent already, having just faced six deliveries. Bravo.
Tempted. Decides against it. Like I suspected, just want to get to that halfway stage without further loss. Just one delivery in the 10th. Tidy over from Ruston Chase, just four runs coming from it. 99 for three after 10.
Follow your heart and come to St. Kitts and Nevis. Kadeem Aline into the attack, his first over. Welcome, Kadeem, says Darren Bravo.
Hero Maximum up on our camera gantry. Up above us, Bish. Would have gone very close to one of our cameramen up there, I think. Cross seam swing. Beautiful swing of the bat. Bravo. He's on a mission here today.
How Kadeem responds to this, whether he shows his variation in skill. Cameramen are safe, thank goodness. Love you guys. Pays off. And again, Simon, you've been here before in Hero CPL. The fan base, not necessarily located in the respective countries where the franchises are from, but so many people set aside their Hero CPL time at this time of year, invested emotionally in their respective teams. And we feel for them. We cheer them on. We thank them. More teams riding into Warner Park later this afternoon. Warriors taking on the Patriots.
Yeah, and as you said, Bish, it's worldwide now too. These teams having ownership around the world. Parts of America, India, of course, some of the owners involved now, similar to IPL franchises. That is what we have in store for you later on today. We've got to get this one over and done with first, but the Amazon Warriors and the Patriots have arrived, or are arriving. And like you say, you're just waiting, sitting at home, wherever you may be, enjoying the CPL action. Knight Riders are doing everything they can to chase this target down. It's still a long way away. A wicket or two changes things quickly. Amazon Warriors arriving, the Patriots. Haven't the crowd got behind them?
Darren Bravo will feel he missed out on that occasion. With pace on the ball and a short fine leg, he knocked himself in the thigh, and he's still upset with himself for missing out. Does he make your dream 11? If you download the app and you log on, make your teams. Does DL make your team? Mark DL, superb today, absolutely brilliant. Next semi-final coming up later, Ruston Chase. Very clever from Dinesh Ramdin, his first boundary of his innings.
Yeah, tough, isn't it, for Kadeem Aline here. There's no real pace on this, it's just a gentle full toss. 122 kilometers per hour, Ramdin has a full bag of tricks as far as these dinky shots are concerned, as most wicketkeepers do, and that is a freebie.
Seifert and Pollard still to come, remember. One 12 for three.
Some big scores. Mark Dale was outstanding, then Tim David and David Visa at the back end. But at the moment, TKR are motoring along.
Last over for Ruston Chase. Can he make an impact with a wicket? Just try to overhit it, as opposed to maybe just striding in and lofting it down the ground or extra cover.
Well, I love this today from Darren Bravo. It's critical of his one from seven. And he's come out today with intent right from the start. Even if he had hit one of those balls to the fielder, I wouldn't have been critical. Because he's shown real intent today, and I love this about his matchup is spin. So come out and take it to the spinners. He's keeping up the run rate, doing a great job at the moment. Still got a lot of batting to come. So I have no issue with the way he's playing today. I think it's very good from a team point of view.
Just wondered if I could take this further, not saying that he'll go on to win the game or he'll go on to get a big score, but just from a principal point of view, whether that could be the type of intent in every innings. Doesn't have to be big shots, but it's avoiding dot ball buildup. Left home early, Dinesh Ramdin. And he left home early as well to get here to win the Hero Fan of the Match award. Gladiator. A knight. Knight rider, they say. So part of the kingdom. That's his release shot. We've talked about it time and again against the spin. Did slot sweep to mid wicket?
Plenty of it, not a lot of risk as well, because he hasn't looked to hit it all the way intentionally. He's sort of rolled the wrists on it, but he's got it so well, it's gone flat for six. No fielder at mid-wicket. The fielder is, or was, a lot squarer. He's now just moved a touch.
I feel he missed out there, rammed in.
In answer to your question about Darren Bravo, yes, in my opinion, that is how he should play more often, with the very same intent. And it's not about intent to hit boundaries all the time, but it's the intent to go bang down the ground for one, hit it through mid-wicket hard, just play, you know, that sweep shot that he loves to play off the spinners as well. You can show intent without having to hit the ball over and to the boundary time and time again. You're running, the intent you walk out to the middle with.
Even in defense, which is the other extreme of a scale, footwork. Last ball for Ruston Chase.
No.
Oh, Bravo's a long way down. Wonder if that was an under edge. 119 for three.
Just got tied down a little bit at the back end of his innings. And they had a small lull after he was out as well. But then it was finished off beautifully by Tim David and David Visa. Some real power. 70 runs off the last four overs.
Wahab Riaz back, and we saw Dwayne Bravo. When he played against his brother, looked to utilize his bowler short sometimes and into the body. And there Wahab goes short, so it's a message all around the Caribbean. You missed it last year, but remember talking about Mark Dial. I played with his father. It's a well-known story. Dion Ryan Dial, when I started in 1987, I think it was, first-class cricket, his dad was an opening batsman. Played a couple of games, played against Ghana and Barbados in Barbados, which was a hair-raising experience against the marshals and guys of this world. But was a very productive batsman at domestic level. Similar build. I don't think he had the power of his son. So it's great to see a legacy being passed on and a pedigree.
Yeah, no, I mean, nice to see. It's great when you see fathers and sons. I mean, it's nice to see Dominic Drake's here as well. And I'm sure there's others around, but you see, you know, when you commentate, as I do around the world now, and I see the sons of guys I played with, Rod Latham's son, Tom, Ken Rutherford's son, Hamish. You know, there's sons all over the place now of guys we played with, Bish, that I don't know whether that's a good thing, that we're getting older, or that we're able to commentate on guys that we played with and friends and teammates, lads, and enjoy their success as well.
I enjoy it, actually. You can't hold the hands of time still. We're all getting older. From birth, we get older. We don't get younger. But you look at Lendl Simmons, relation to West Indies coach Phil Simmons. Number of these gentlemen, Ravi Rampal, his two kids love the game. There's Lendl on the right of the screen. Dominic Drake, son of Vasbert Drakes. So I love that legacy passing on. It's Ravi's young men.
Well, a name that's been in and around New Zealand domestic cricket for quite some time, a young lad called Logan Van Beek, will be going to the T20 World Cup Now, he is the grandson, for those of you who remember, Simpson Gillen, played for the West Indies. Call him Sammy. Who went on tour to New Zealand in 1956, I think it was, something around about there, and decided to stay on. So his grandson, Logan van Beek, will be playing for Holland in the T20 World Cup. Bruce Paradeau was another that went out and decided to stay in New Zealand on that tour as well, I think.
Of course, you talk about Sammy Gillen. His relations are members of the Queen's Park Cricket Club, where Bravos and Pollard originated or heightened their game and has had a hand in their development. Charles Gillen, Jeffrey Gillen. Neck and crop from Waha after a few softening up. He hits the target dead on.
I think Queen's Park just went silent. That is beautiful from Wahab. That's exactly why he's been brought back. Had a tough start, a couple of average overs at the start of the innings. But he has come back with a vengeance. Is that okay? Get your foot down. Oh, my goodness me. Oh, take it back a little bit. Can we go? I think that's just after. I can see a touch. I can see a small margin, Bish. A small margin behind the line. Poles everywhere. Bravo on his way, out for 25 off 16, 121 for 4.
New incoming batsman, captain for Trinbago Knight Riders, number 55, Kairan Olar.
Kyron Pollard, game on the line. It's a good strategic move from Andre Fletcher to get his quickie back into the attack. In one delivery, in the over at Kyron Pollard. Just saw a little bit of, I wonder if it tailed back into to Darren Bravo there as well. Does he go short or bluff and go length away from Pollard? Nip back quite nicely off the pitch. Slip in place. Pollard off the mark straight away. Successful over. 1-2-2 for 4.
Now, look, it may still go the TKR way. I would love to have seen a walk in at 4. Just think ownership. He is and has been possibly the best batsman through the tournament consistently. I love to have seen him walk out at four, but not to be. That run rate up at 12. Angostura, chill, refreshing moment, winner. Absolutely brilliant. 200 US for the first of the semi-finals today. Tell you what, I was late to the party too on the Angostura chill. I'm loving it. I've had a delivery. So good. 12 and over required now. Not a lot of time to get in.
Alzari Joseph back. He might go hard into the pitch against Pollard. That's badly lined. Coming back into it on the Winvis predictor, but important to look at the field as well. The predictor is good. Top right of your screen, that short fine leg is wide. Joseph cannot afford to be too straight. Deep fielder's out leg side. Oh, I have a feeling. I have a feeling. Had he hit, we would have seen a curtain coming down, perhaps. Oh, no,
wait. It was hesitation. He was late. Safe. What do you think? What do you think now? Not sure. Would have been tight. Would have been really tight. Great work from the bowler, though.
Slight change in the field. That man who was at short fine leg has gone back to fine leg. So will he go hard into the pitch and short at Ramdin? Goes length for one.
We know the power of Corin Pollard, but to do 12 and over from seven overs out, not easy. To do it for the last three, yep, that's okay. He's going to need some help in the early part.
One left. David Visa has a couple. Listened intently to Mark Diel talk about the little needle between the two teams at the end of the final last year that's driving the Kings for a little bit of retribution.
I like this. The aggression is good. Corin Pollard knows what he possesses, so he's not overly bothered. Saw him just decide to turn the switch on a couple of nights ago, and 22 and over is not an issue when he wants to. I think he's assessing the dangers. He knows what overs are left. I'm going to have to bring the medium pace of David Visa back, which he loves. An over out of, or two overs out of Javor Royal or Kadim Aline, Kimo Paul.
Kimo's only bowled three deliveries in the last four games. I'm a fan of him getting an over, but. Ramdin has to step up as well. He's going at just about a run a ball. That's just over that. And that can't be satisfactory.
And I've long said it, and I've talked to you about it too, Imbish. Corin Pollard is a far better player than at times he's been pigeonholed, and that's why today, 200 on the board, captain, just walk out at number four for me. And as I said, it may turn out fine, it may be all right, but I'd just love to see him stride out there at number four instead of Ramden.
Will be 127 for four after 14. Discussions going on with Fletcher and his parliament, including Wahab, including David Visa, including Roston Chase, and the two umpires are saying, come on.
We've just seen Darren Sammy sideline with Wahab. So that's the message that's been delivered. Wahab Riaz has gone out there, he's delivered a message, courtesy of Darren Sammy, and the message was Chemo Paul.
To me, this is a big over. Pollard and Ramden will be discussing this as an over that they will try. Remember what I'm saying, folks. Try to get ahead of the game. Paul has been averaging about 10 per over so far this season. So when you're looking for a big over, you don't want to score 70 off the last five or have to. You want to get ahead of the game. It offers Chemo Paul as well, folks, the chance to create a false shot.
Yeah, it's that matchup thing we talk about so often, isn't it? Kyron Potter will like this matchup. He loves medium pace. Genuine quick. We've seen him hit it before, but it's not his favorite. He doesn't mind spin, but he loves just a gentle 130 medium pacer. Ramden, will he look to just play those little dinky shots, the ramps, or is it just about getting one, get Pollard on strike?
Not a great start. First ball four.
You can see the intent straight away, though, from Dinesh Ramden. They like it. They like the matchup. His first really big shot he's tried to play.
I wonder what Wahab said to him. I wonder if it's a piece off the ball. I want to give a little insight, a little bit of knowledge. One of the senior bowlers in this tournament in the West Indies team has had a chat with Chemo Paul. Chemo has been searching for information how to get better, how to structure his overs. And I was so happy to hear that he's been having a chat with one or two key and experienced players. Another big ball coming up. Got away with that. His short, fine leg, that would have been four.
Yeah, and straight away you're under pressure as a bowler. Four off the first ball. Where does he go to Kyron Pollard here? We're thinking pace off. The field is set predominantly leg side long on, deep mid wicket, deep backward square. Does he want it changed? Yeah, we're eating away at time here. This is when it always does. Inevitably, these key games, knockout situations, they do eat away a little more time, don't they, than we normally see. So now it must be full and wide or pace off.
Yeah, the field is suggesting that it's more of an off stump line, at least. Whether it's pace on or pace off, it has to be more off stump.
Roston Chase doing a lot of the marshalling of the troops as well. He had a game as vice captain, I think.
Oh, goodness. That's not wide enough of off stump. Alzari Joseph is racing towards Kimo Paul. Pollard, it's a hero maximum.
Oh, he's racing towards Fletcher because he's just got another message from Darren Sammy. It's Slotsville. That's what it is. It is right in the slot. Corin Pollard just licking his lips. Thank you very much. Now, bowler under enormous pressure.
Look, he's a fantastic ball striker, Corin Pollard. And he's on that list of Hero Maximum's race. And it's no easy way to bowl to. You'd be lucky to bluff and go into the pitch with no one from mid-wicket to fine leg. And he has such a long reach. They're watching closely. They're playing later. Is it wide yorker? Risking a wide, is that the case? Whether pace off or pace on? It was attempted wide yorker, but neither Visa nor Mark Dial. Were able to get to it.
I'm sorry, but that is not good enough. You've got to go for this. What's he doing? What's he doing? Mark Dial, I'm sorry, but this is game on the line. There's no tomorrow, fella. Oh, I hate to be too critical, Mark Dial, but that is... Oh, you batted beautifully, but it's body on the line's time.
That's where it's difficult, you know, for Pollard. It's full and wide, it's attempted yorker, but he's got such reach. 19 off the over so far.
And you feel, he just bowled a couple of slot balls here. This one again, it's wide. The line is better, but half volley is a half volley, unfortunately, when you've got that much power like Pollard does. He's got that reach. It's not easy. There's a lot of others haven't found it easy as well, Kimo Paul. Don't feel bad.
Ooh, I think it was a good call, actually. When I saw it live, I think it was a good call by the umpire.
Yeah, I'm with you. He hasn't moved, has he, Corin Pollard here? Oh, touch. A touch.
Wide, come on. Don't be Danny Morrison and me. Don't go Danny Morrison and me.
No, I'm with you. I think that's wide. I'm okay with that. Big ball. Big ball. Finish it well. I know it's been tough.
It could be two. Will be 22 off the over. 149 for four. 57 required.
Last stanza, the last five. 57 from 30 now is what the defending champs need to get into the final tomorrow morning. And they've got their skipper out there who was pumping along as merry way as ever in this fabulous format. 19 from 9, striking at 211. Doesn't bother with fours, he deals in maximums. And Ramden came out at a tricky little time. He's hung around and played the sheet anchor. Just been able to manipulate it, work it. He's hit a six himself, to be fair, and a couple of boundaries. So he's striking at 121. He's not quite happy, though. And David Visa. He's got two for 18 from a couple. pressure on the bowlers. And now that Fletcher and the coaching staff have turned to one of the overseas stars, now with a lot of experience, got rid of the dangerous Colin Munro. Nothing silly, let's get Pollard back on strike. Sammy B, there's the 150 up for the Knight Riders.
Yeah, and a good partnership between these two, 29 of 16, like you mentioned. The experience of Karen Pollard once again coming to the fore, the experience of Dennis Ramden as well, understanding his role. And I just wonder if Karen Pollard would target Visa like he targeted Kimo Paul over a piece for Alzari Joseph and Wahab Riaz. So that's two overs after this that you can bank on from St. Lucia Kings. Who would be the other two? That's the question. Kimo Paul, 22 in that over. Ruston Chase has bowled out. And that's where the area of concern really is for the Kings.
Field spread deep and straight. Oh, he's given that wide.
The new one.
Not a lot of margin there. So the umpires have pretty strict about things. Pollard swapping gloves. Yeah, the breeze not quite as strong as it has been, so humidity factor, sweaty palms and all.
Look at where this fielder is positioned. Might be Kadima Lean, straight back past the bowler. Karen Pollard usually hits the ball dead straight. Must be interested in the line from Visa. Is he going to bowl wide? Protection, extra cover and cover boundary. A huge heave from Pollard. Just changes gloves. That required run rate just under 12, so still manageable.
Just wanted, he lost a bit of shape there. He wanted to smash it into next week. Just when his head came up, just a little too early, his eyes lit up. So smart, smart from Visa. Brave, the change of pace, went for a slow Yorker. There's that straight hit. So it's useful still. Yeah, it's incredible feel, isn't it? The straight hit, the long on, long off. Straightish, given that it's Kyron Pollard and his prowess at going downtown.
Intense moments for the management of the Kings. Can Dinesh Ramden find the boundary? If he can, it will ease the pressure. It will help the Knight Riders. Where can he find it? Short third man, short fine leg. Just suspect it might be pace off as well. And they won't mind these too much, the singles, that is. Pollard back on strike, so he'll be searching desperately for a boundary. And with every single, with every dot delivery, that required rate just keeps going up. 12.23 at the moment.
Yeah, I've kept in check because of the skipper. That strike rate at 180, pretty much. And the confirmation with the cutie graphic. Straight hit for Pollard. Fetch this, please. Life boy clean strike has disappeared out of here.
Yeah, in the direction of the cruise ship as well. What power from this man, Pollard. He continues to do Pollard things here. Wide, a little bit too full, and he knew immediately Visa. Didn't even bother to look. Now he does. That has gone miles. And with that six, Danny Morrison, the required run rate dips under 12 now, 11.28. So a dot ball or a single pushes it up, of course, and a boundary sends it down quite considerably. 10 runs of the over so far. And take away that six, it would have been an excellent over. Conversation between Fletcher and his bowler. What can they do? Can they muster something?
Now, the other beauty here, in terms of what goes on, and it's so fast and furious normally, but the ball disappearing here at Warner, they have to get another ball, so the fourth official has to come out. If they do find it off, and then you've got to clean it, sanitize it. So there is that time for extra players. They run on with a drink and maybe a change of gloves or even a change of bat. Message from the dressing room. To the skipper, have a quick chat from the coach. What's going to go on? What are you feeling? What are you thinking? Who are we going to target? It's going rather swimmingly here for Pollard and TKR. 26 from a dozen. Randon's doing his thing as well, but it's perfect here for another big slam dunk from Pollard. One to go, 10 off. Big ballless again for the Kings and Visa. Hello, spicy, yes, celebration, learn to fly again, David Visa going nuts with an El Dorado celebration. This is a huge, huge moment in the first semi.
And a standing ovation from the coach, Andy Flower. They know how big of a wicket this is, all good there, no concerns. A massive blow by the St. Lucia Kings. Final delivery of the over went wide into the pitch. Andrew Fletcher has put down a few, but not this time. Magnificent bowling from David Visa to get that wicket. Karen Pollard, the captain, has to go for 26. 159 for 5.
Key player, Tim Seifert, and he is such a good striker and a great finisher, so he's in at a crucial time. Four overs left, 47 from 24. Asking rate, well, it's almost 12, it's pretty much call it that. And the skipper has gone. Massive moment in the semi-final. Strong. Yeah, it's gone there. Back to 28 because of the dismissal of Pollard. Fascinating when you look at where Pollard played that delivery and the magnetism of the straight hit. It's such a go-to area for Pollard. And he wanted to hit it back straight over the bowler's head when maybe a cut would have been the order of the day. Always easy in hindsight. Yeah, watch how wide this is, and he wants to go straight. He's thinking maybe, how about one of those big booming uppercuts and a go for six? But he's just so lethal. Darren Sammy. There's been a lot of messages coming out. Yeah, that's back to you. Good work. Yeah, thanks, Skip. Thanks, Coach. Thanks, Darren. Seifert, he'd dearly love to get in and get settled here. Randon says no.
You're 100% right with that call on the wicket of Pollard. He practiced that square cut after the ball went up in the air and he was walking out. It would have been a better option for him, but as you rightly mentioned, he wanted to go downtown. Scored so many of his runs in that direction. The field was in front of him. There was no one square on the boundary.
Yeah, I love spicy. Great stuff. field set accordingly. So again, they've just got a dot, single and a single, and asking right now creeps towards 13s. 45 from 21 here. So bowling. Wahab's got that one up his sleeve. Visa certainly. And the bottom three bowlers there. We need one from you, chaps. Who's it going to be? Who are they going to go to? Yeah, timing not there. It's hard to start anytime, even if it's a good surface. Still got to get in, get set.
And that's why Ramdin is so important here. He's in, he's set. 22 deliveries. Has to find a boundary somewhere. Very good square off the wicket. So I wouldn't be too surprised if he gives himself some room and tries to cut it over point. Joseph might just want to be tight in terms of his line.
Yeah, trying to get the boot in the way. No timing, so it's only going to be one. So take that. We've got one to go, so four singles. Joseph has to finish off well here for the Kings now.
Yeah, this has been a superb over. Yeah, huge gap on the leg side. So that length has to be full. He's searching for the Yorkers, 78 meters.
Oh dear, it was length. It's disappeared. It's gone for four, but he has missed his Yorker. Lifebuoy clean strike to finish the over. 167 for five. At 205, they breached 200, which was really crucial for the Kings psychologically, thanks to Visa and David. Some really good contributions there. Mark Dowell at the top there. And it'll apply 167 for 5 from 17. So now you look at it and you look at Seifert, and he's played some wonderful cameos in season 9, very capable of tracking down 39 from 3. Yes, it's 13s. Do not give any away freebies as a bowling unit. And so you've got Wahab to do it now. So this is the 18th. You talk about that 19th so crucial. The 18th crucial and the 19th. A little squeeze there. So if you think about Visa, Visa's got one more. Does he bowl that crucial 19th and leave someone with a decent amount of runs to play with to bowl a 20th and final over? That'd be my call. Wahab, back to Visa. And then, let's see. 3 men at the bottom. You'd think of young Elaine, you'd maybe a bit young, so go with Chemo Paul, but he's disappeared too. But to be fair, that was against Pollard. So there's a lot to weigh up if it gets down to that. Oh, watch him. Watch the timing. And those wicket-keeper batters who hit the ball in unique posies.
In a very tall order for the Knight Riders at this stage, 36 from 16. They need to get at least 10 in this over, at least. And seven more to bring it to 20, 29, 28. And then that penultimate over go really hard. The Kings, on the other hand, if they can get Seifert and just the bowlers to come, really.
It's clean. It's not straight enough. Yeah, it's mounting, so this is good. So a single, you don't mind. Even the odd two. So suddenly, 35 from 15. Over to you, Dinesh Ramdin, who's, 28 from 24. Not the biggest striker, but I tell you what, if he gets it in his arc or zone, capable. big time. So now, change in the field. Fletcher has got Elzari Joseph at a orthodox fine leg. Deep backward squares come up inside there. Long on, a mid-wicket that's straight on the fence. And then you've got long off fairly straight, deep extra cover point. And third man is up. And another position there behind third man you see in the modern game of fielders at a short third man and also like a fly slip. Now he's cuffed it a little bit. One will do though. Yeah, Tim David, he's strong.
Yeah, still can't find the boundary. And rammed in. But a good over. And following up a good one from Elzari Joseph. We need to close it off. Kari Pierre, Aki Lusain, Ali Khan, Ravi Rampol to come. And Kari Pierre can't find the boundaries. We saw him before in a previous tournament doing that. But for the neutrals out there, lots of people will be supporting the Kings.
Always pick the man out. No, well played. Good experience. Hold it. No need to get carried away. And even a ricochet off the stumps. Goes for runs. Most frustrating. So this is good. Just another single. So six off. One to go. Another key delivery. Last ball of any over, really, in T20. But particularly now in the death overs. And you've got Seifert. But you've got Ramden on strike. And then it'll be fascinating to see who the Kings go with that penultimate over, the 19th.
Ramden needs a boundary. He needs to find the ropes, whether it is a four or a six. Wahab needs to close the over out with a dot or a single.
Massive ball. Gone! Down the throat went Yorker. Ramden has mistimed this, and it has cost him and TKR dearly.
Very well composed with the catch. Hanging their heads already. But if you notice, Dinesh Ramden, we'll see it a little bit later on. A good catch, simple enough. But Dinesh Ramden crossed Tim Seifert, and Seifert was trying to get back on the other side to retain the strike. In the end, Ramden goes for 29, 173 for six.
Goes for Trinbago Knight Riders. Dinesh Ramden out for 29. Bowled by Wahab Riaz. Caught by Kadeem Ali. New incoming batsman, number seven, Akhil Hussain. Trinbago Knight Riders needs 33
runs from 12 balls. Wickets in hand 4 to win the game. Change in bowling,
number 96, David
Rees,
will be bowling from Northern End Media Centre.
Six down of the Knight Riders. Here's Akhil Hussain. He's fatted a couple in an innings recently. And hit it out of the ballpark, so he's no slouch. But the interesting thing, with 33 off a dozen deliveries, and it is going to be David Visa, as we thought, bowl that important key 19th over, and then see how many are left for the 20th to bowl it. Who's going to weigh that up? We don't know yet. But Seifert's lost the strike. They were both running, as you do, naturally go with it, and really he didn't want to cross. But because the ball hung so long, out to long off, it's meant Seifert's lost the strike. Bizarre. Those little things, those little 1%ers that Ian Bishop goes on about. But all very easy to say from up here. When the pressure's on, you're looking for runs. And the ball goes way out the outfield at long off. So now, we've got the new man in, Akhil Hussain, to face the informed David Visa. Oh, I want to see this down the line. Very strict on the wides, these two. Samuel B?
Yeah, it's a wide, but the wicket first. Dinesh Ramden didn't connect it near the middle. And look at Tim Seifert trying to get back on strike, but a little bit too late. The catch was completed. Yeah, the reactions in the dugout. Started off with a wide. Let's see what happens next.
Sweet, sweet strike for six. Just what the Knight Riders needed. No, he can't strike a ball. Akil Hussain.
And look at the difference in reaction in the dugout. From despair to ecstasy. Magnificent strike from Akil in the slot. What's it now? 26 off 11, Danny Morrison. Nail-biting affair.
Just what you want in a sudden death semi. Brave, and the experience and class of Visa. So let's see what else he's going to come up with. Just been pumped for six with a slot ball, and then you bowl this. Got to get it right, and he did.
It's a length. Maybe just a little bit too full on that one as well. He has to pull that length back. Don't get hit straight down the ground. If you have to get hit at this stage, let him hit you square.
Up, up. Yeah, really important catch. Another big moment. Kareem Aline. You beauty.
You took the catch of Ramlin, now takes the catch of Akil Hussain into the pitch. Slow ball once again. And this one was always going away from him. Again, kept his composure. Kareem Aline, good fielder. Wickets continue to fall here. Hussain goes for six, 180 for seven.
It's my mate, the Frenchman, Harry Pierre. He's replaced his good mate, Akil Hussain. Seifert. Gone! There you go! He's on a hat-trick again! Oh, someone getting the best of you. You betcha. Visa, another fifer in Hero CPL Season 9.
Stop it, David Visa. 5 for 25. No, 5 for 35. Big wicket again, Seifert. A good catch from Ruston Chase. Look at that El Dorado celebration. Game, set, and match. 180 for 8. Seifert goes for 10.
David Visa on a hat trick. Oh, could have done with a chop on there. Wow. He's been told it's his third fifer in Hero CPL, Sammy.
Absolutely brilliant. He came in into this tournament as a replacement. But he's done a brilliant job. 5 for 25. No, 5 for 35, final delivery, 26 from 7.
Up, up, up. 5 for 39 in the end to go with his 5 for 25. Quite outstanding, his contribution, given that he was late to the tournament. And now on the brink. So who are we going to have? Kemo Paul, who couldn't quite get to that. I think it's going to be Kemo Paul to bowl this. His only overs disappeared for 21, courtesy of Kyron Pollard. Of course, Pollard's out. They need 22 to win it. Carey Pierre and Ali Khan. Hello, hello, and goodbye. There's the ninth nail in it. Kareem Aleen, you beauty.
Three catches for Kareem Aleen. And he's enjoying every moment of it. Not these guys, they're not. Kemo Paul entrusted with the responsibility of the final over, slower ball. Wow, good judgment. Really well composed once again, Kareem Aleen, and success for Kemo Paul. And Pierre goes without scoring, 184 for 9.
Trinbago Knight Riders needs 22 runs from 5 balls. Wicket in hand, 1.
Ali Khan has been joined by Ravi Rampol. It's the equation. It was 22 of the last, but we've just had the dismissal of Carey Pierre. They got a duck. And so now, the last man in, Ravi Rampol, has had a wonderful time with the ball. Ali Khan on strike. It's we said he came off his thigh. Interesting. Or just breeze, just caress the pad. Here's the wicket.
Yeah, good slower delivery from Kemo Paul. The line was what he was looking for across the left-hander. And not enough. Just, but not enough.
Yeah, it was a brave off-cutter. Good slow and off-pace delivery. It's gone to the moon. Is this the end? Catch it. Oh, what a ripping catch! With another one, and look at the celebrations here. Talk about El Dorado going berserk here, the Blues, because it means, that's right, cricket lovers, we're going to have a new winner on the Hero CPL trophy in 2021. Great scenes, wonderful victory to the St. Lucia Kings, winning the toss and going up front and posting 205 to win this first semi-final. Great drama under the sunshine of St. Kitts and Nevis here at Warner Park. The underdogs have come good and won here.
And the Davids have slain Goliath. Kemo Paul getting the final wicket. He was celebrating long in advance. And fittingly, Mark Dial, the final nail in the coffin. Man who started it off with the bat, ends it with the catch. And look at that, raw emotion. And why not? For the second successive year, the St. Lucia Kings have made it to the final, the grand final. And they'll await the winner of the second semi-final. But brilliant performance all around from these guys. And fittingly, and well-deserved, they're into the final once again.
Yeah, the defending champions are out. The mighty have fallen. And there's a great scene here because they've lost Faf du Plessis. Of course, he got some very, very useful runs. He got that 120 off 60 earlier in the tournament and was in a wonderful little purple patch. Was Faf. So tough going when you lose your skipper, an inspirational leader as Faf du Plessis. But now they get to the final. Andy Flower, coaching staff, shaking hands with all and sundry. They're wanting to track down 206 to win. And in the end, fell somewhat short. Some good contributions there. Narayan 30, 28 to Monroe, 29 to Ramden. Bravo got 25. Pollard, wonderful striking, got to 26. And then it was all over. When he got out, you just thought, hello, hang on. And 184 all out, 19 and a half overs with 22 extras.
The bowling from the St. Lucia Kings, all-around effort, group effort. Zari Joseph stands out, 1 for 24, along with Wahab Riaz, 2 for 35. But David Visa, a second five-wicket haul for him this year, 5 for 39. Really good combined effort. St. Lucia Kings, 205 for 4. Knight Riders won 84 all out in 19.3. The Kings winning by 21 runs.
What action we're having in Hero CPL 2021. A high scoring encounter and runs were at a premium. So too wickets. Our fun 88 man of the match is David Visa. David, the ending of your effort with yourself and Tim David. Talk to us about the planning.
Look, we got a little tight down there in the middle with the spinners on. You know, Sunil Nalan's a top-class bowler, and we couldn't quite get him away. So we knew that if we could just hold him out and, you know, maybe attack at the end. You know, thankfully for us, you know, they missed their mark a little bit faster. And, you know, Tim's a phenomenal striker. He's been doing it, you know, this whole season. So, you know, there's a reason why Isley Goddard is one of the best in the world. So, you know, fortunately for us, it came off today.
You can always look me in the eye. Don't be ashamed. I wouldn't answer too many hard questions. Two fifers. I mean, how does that feel?
Yeah, it's unbelievable, to be honest with you. You know, in this game, you bowl well and you don't get the reward. And then sometimes, you know, everybody else bowls well and you're the guy who picks up the wickets. And I thought, you know, that's what it was like today. Everybody else bowled well and they put the pressure on the batters and, you know, they had to go after me, I suppose. And, you know, I got lucky with the one or two. And, you know, in the end, it just works out.
Very self-deprecating. That over to Kyron Pollard, in which you got Kyron Pollard out. A little bit of your planning without giving away too much. What was your process?
Yeah, look, we know that he's a phenomenal striker and, you know, you miss your mark slightly and it's going to go for six. So, you know, we just tried to keep it out of his hitting zone completely. You know, that last ball was slightly against the plan, but sometimes you just got to go with your gut and, you know, react to what's happening out there. And, you know, Fletch came to me and said, you know, just try it and see what happens. And, you know, in the end, it was a great call from him. So, you know, you've got to give him the credit for that.
Into the final. Happy you came.
Yeah, unbelievable. You know, just thinking, just coming here for one or two games or, you know, maybe not even getting out yet to making the finals. You know, unbelievable. And I'm just enjoying every single moment of it.
Well done.
Thank you.
Thank you, gentlemen. Yes, man of the match, David Visa. And they were asked to track down 206 in the pursuit of it. Well, a little top edge to start from Lendl Simmons. Ride your luck, but he's a good player. And that wasn't the smartest shot going around, it has to be said. The very first over, Alzari Joseph accounts for Lendl Simmons. And the two lefties get together. And a useful little partnership, these two, because they got together and it was 71 off 43 between these two. And they were striking it rather sweetly. Some smart batting, some indifferent bowling, but nervy, you'd have to say, from the Kings. Too short again from Roston Chase. And he'll make you pay every time. Just some very entertaining stuff here, Sammy.
Yeah, 30 for Sunil Narine, 1-6 and 4-4s. But he was looking ominous and very threatening. He tried to go for this Hero Maximum. A good catch from Kadeem Aleen. And then a wicket falling very soon after David Visa got his first. Monroe had to go. The decision to bowl Javor Royal against Darren Bravo, new to the crease, proved costly. Smashed this one straight. Dinesh Ramden was out there for quite some time. And found a boundary there. And another one. This was a flat six over mid-wicket. Wahab Riaz came back into the attack. and saw poles everywhere cleaning up Darren Bravo. And they needed to go, they needed to increase the tempo. And up stepped the captain, Kyron Pollard, a man for every occasion, was just sweating everywhere with these deliveries disappearing. And then trying to go for another David Visa into the surface, Fletcher absolutely made no mistake.
Yeah, the experience of these two bowlers, Wahab and Visa, to the fore. And Hussain, another slower ball from Visa doing the trick. Seifert straight after, bang, caught, Pfeiffer. Was on a hat trick, was David Visa, wasn't to be. 22 off the last over needed, was always going to be a tall ask. And Kadeem Ali, another good catch on the boundary. And then Mark Dale running in, took a beauty. Don't underestimate how difficult that is, and he made it look easy. Kemo Paul celebrates, and so do the rest of the Kings, coaching staff, and all the support staff there, over the moon to get into another final as they did last year. They're back into it in 2021. Rightio, let's go back to Ian Bishop.
Yes, there will be a new champion in Hero CPL this year, but the former champion's leader, Kyron Pollard, is here with me. Kyron, 205 on the pitch, more than you would have expected or not?
No, it was actually a good pitch. I think they came out and they were positive, you know, from the toss. They won the toss and they decided to bat. But, you know, for me, you got to give them credit. I think they played well. They were the better team, you know, today. And, you know, sometimes, you know, when you lose a game like this, you got to give credit to your opposition. You can't win all. But, you know, congratulations to my team. Very, very proud, you know, of the boys and the way how we fought, you know, today. And you can't ask for a better cricket game.
If you had to do it over again, I know you've gone over it. What areas do you feel could have been more decisive?
I just thought somewhere in the middle we gave them a couple too much of boundary balls. But again, you know, having said that, when you look at our bowling performance throughout the entire tournament, you know, the guys have been fantastic. So you can't, you know, just, you know, go there and fold them and said, you know, you could have done this, you could have done that. At the end of the day, we came to play cricket. Everyone was geared up, you know, for this game. And it didn't happen for us. But again, well played to the opposition. And, you know, a lot of people around the Caribbean, around the world, would love to see the back of us. So, you know, there you have it.
Look, it's never easy to go out. What are the positive things, the standout things you feel that TKR have taken out of this tournament?
I think the way we played throughout the entire tournament and we fought, you know, to the end, the way that we bowled, you know, Ravi Rampol, you know, bowling well, coming back into CPL, you know, after a couple of years. Young Akhil Hussain, you know, doing well, you know, for us guys, getting opportunities. And, you know, that's all you want. You want to see good cricket. I thought we played some decent cricket and some great cricket throughout the season. We struggled with the bat, you know, a bit. But, you know, having said that, you know, getting our biggest total, you know, of the series, you know, in a semi-final game, chasing 205, and the way the guys went about to chase it, we were never in doubt. The way we left that dressing room, but again, these things happen and we just have to accept it. So again, we'll sit back and we'll watch, you know, the final tomorrow and may the best team win.
Very big of you to give that sort of credit to the St. Lucia Kings. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
That was Kyron Pollard, the captain of TKR, Andre Fletcher, the leader, and must be a very proud leader of the St. Lucia Kings. Just come this way a little bit, Andre, cameraman, it's a little challenge. On getting to the final again, tell us a little bit about how you feel and how the dressing room feels.
It's a great feeling to know that last year we got to the finals and we didn't get over the line, but this year we wanted to get back there. We didn't want to make it look like it was a fluke. And trust me, the dressing room, we are pumped up and everyone is looking forward for the final. It's not over yet, but you know, we really want to get over that line.
Yeah, it's still a journey. Mark Dial and David Visa, a little bit about their contributions.
Yeah, Mark played very well.